ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
Ladies all white. These ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white, these ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi. Ladies all white, these ain't no harachi.
Yeah!
50 flow, in Hirachi.
What it do, what it do.
Hey, it's Friday.
It's most definitely Friday. How y'all doing out there, Mickey? How you doing?
I'm doing good. How you doing, sir?
I'm pretty good.
I see you green. I see you.
Hey, I'm pretty good, man. Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button. Share the live. Subscribe to our channel if you're not subscribed. You know what I'm saying? It's finna be a good live, so y'all make sure y'all tap in. Let's sound bite with another salute, salute, salute. Iceberg, what it do? Michael, what it do? Hey, Mickey, did you tell your people like what you got going on before we get into the show?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
You ain't telling what you. I'm talking about for tomorrow.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Just know, okay. I'm fixing flights, you know.
Okay, okay.
I'm going out of town. But no, now you know better.
Okay,
now,
okay.
Okay, now don't start.
I ain't know this early.
We ain't even started the show yet.
I'm saying I ain't know. Did you tell your peoples or not? Like I ain't, you know. So I had to make sure.
You know, look. Shout out to the truth team, but you know we be having imposters over there.
Right.
I'll say it when I get back.
Okay, okay, for sure, for sure. Hey, man, y'all know we got a good show going on tonight. We got a big show going on tonight. We got some topics we got to talk about. And it's a lot of stuff that been going on this week. So y'all already know we got to get into it. But before we get into it, I just want to know where y'all from, man. Like, what y'all represent? Do we got Chicago? Do we got Florida? Do we got South Carolina, North Carolina, Charlotte? Like, where y'all from? Houston, Texas.
Rep your hood, let me see. Z's up, let me see. P's down, let me see. Throw it up, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Rep your hood, let me see. Z's up, let me see. P's down, let me see. Throw it up, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Rep your hood, let me see. Z's up, let me see. P's down, let me see. Throw it up, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Let me see, let me see. Rep your hood, let me see. Up. Let me see, peace down. Let me see, throw it up. Let me see, 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 let me see. Let me see. Rep your hood. Let me see, Z's up. Let me see, peace down. Let me see, throw it up. Let me see, 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 let me see. Let me see. Rep your hood. Let me see, Z's up. Let me see, peace down. Let me see, throw it up. Let me see, 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 let me see. Let me see. Rep your hood. Let me see, Z's up. Let me see, peace down. Let me see, throw it up. Let me see. Let me see.
Hey, salute, salute, man. We got some of everybody in the building today.
Hey,
man,
shout out to everybody. But I just got to call somebody out real quick.
Go ahead.
Me, your ass right down here in South Carolina. Some of you in South Side, Jamaica. Shout out to New York. But you know, you is in the South, girl.
Hey, man. Miss me said she holding it down for New York, man. God damn, man. You are. She say, hey, she got to tell you where she from. You feel me?
And then what's so crazy, I used to live in Pittsburgh. Shout out to Pittsburgh. I used to go to Lincoln Elementary School. And I used to live in Detroit, too. Shout out to Detroit. Boom.
Detroit, for sure, for sure, for sure.
Well, I was born in Detroit, actually.
Hey, I just want to show y'all two. I just want to show y'all like two, three videos before we get into the content, man. This shit just was like crazy to me. Hold on, let me show
you. Hold on, before we get into all this, because knowing you,
go ahead.
You know, telling what the fuck type of video we about to watch. Y'all already know. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, tell a friend, and pull up on Triple Threat Friday. As always, my legendary disclaimer, okay? All information contained in this live is for entertainment. Heavy on a mother effing entertainment, little education purposes only. All information used during this live is per the Fair Use Act. And any conclusion that you draw is on you and your mama. Nobody on this panel in the chat. So let's get it.
Hey, man. I just want to know. Like, I know in the foreign countries and shit like that, it'd be a lot of, you know, outside restaurants going on. You hear me? But I just want to know, like, how...
Is that a rat?
Listen, man. Listen. This is what I just want to know. I don't know what it's... I know this is a foreign country. But I just want to know, how can people, like, tolerate this situation? Look at these rats right here, man. Look at this shit, man. Look at
my joke must have didn't land when I said, is that Chicago?
Oh. Wait, what? Damn it, man. Oh, you shooting shots. You shooting shots for them. Now, look, though, but they serving people this shit, though. They serving people. Like, this is a restaurant.
Yeah. Hell, that's how we do now. That's why all the rats rich. Or getting rich.
Feeding them, huh?
Feeding them.
Aries,
give us a few minutes. We're gonna get to see. So you got the troop team. Like, what the fuck is this we seen in the title? Because I copied your title tonight. Okay,
hey.
Like, what the fuck?
We finna get to it in 2 minutes. Now, this right here is another clip because I felt like I had to show y'all this because a lot of this goes on. You know, people be on social media telling y'all, you know what I'm saying, they got trips and boat trips and plane trips and hotels and half price off. Well, this what may happen if you buy one of them trips for half price off right here, man.
Right here, come on board the ship, charge whatever you want, and you ain't gonna get caught. But guess what?
On February 8th, 2024, in Florida, police were called to a cruise ship concerning a woman who had used stolen credit cards to book her journey. Before their arrival, ship security had already taken the woman into custody.
Did somebody ask you to come on the cruise ship and do something?
No.
She just went.
Go
ahead.
Nothing.
What did she tell you to do? Nothing. Whoever she is. Listen.
But it should be my name, though.
Why did the person tell you to come on the cruise today? You've never been on a cruise before. You booked your cruise recently. Who told you to come on the cruise?
Someone booked the cruise. And they told us they asked about the excursions and basically it was something to do to get away.
So someone told you to book the cruise. They booked it for you. Who is that someone?
I don't know her.
How did you find out about her?
So some stranger just...
No, it was on the internet.
It was on the internet. Mm. So some stranger on the internet that you don't know.
Basically saying
hey, I'll pay for your cruise.
If you do what?
No, you have to pay them. You have to cash out money and everything. I never asked no questions. How much or none of that. She told me I need to get her some money up front.
So it's through Cash App. So you have the invoice on the Cash App?
No, not Cash App. She stayed in the city, so I can actually go up.
You know. Did that same person tell you to get...
You thought it was going to be free ride here? Come on.
That shit sounded like a bunch of bullshit for one. Like, she couldn't even keep it together. She used that goddamn credit card herself to book that goddamn cruise, okay? Ain't no homegirl, no girl somewhere. Mm-mm. You gotta unmute for us to hear you.
My bad. I had to show that because it's a lot of people that, you know what I'm saying, they do it. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of people. I ain't trying to, you know, stop nobody hustle, but it's a lot of people who buy that half price off and all this shit here.
Just like those TPN.
Right, right.
Yeah, yeah, those TPNs is not legit. If you didn't know, now you know.
Right. Now, I ain't gonna lie. It's how you use it.
Use what?
But the CPN... The
CPNs are illegal, period. Ain't know how you use it.
It's illegal, but it's like this. You have to put it in your name.
No, no, no. It's not going to be in your name. Then it's not a CPN. A CPN is stolen social security numbers. The only way you can actually get a legit CPN, I'm talking about some dire shit got to happen, and it's free, and it comes from the Social Security Administration. Not your homegirl up the street in apartment A.
Okay, so technically, it's not illegal if you do it the right way.
No, 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 no. Listen, you're not going to be... Can't nobody sell you a legal, okay, CPN, because no such thing. Because the Social Security Administration will give you, basically, the new Social Security number, they will give it to you for free. What it do, Prince? Long time no see.
Okay, okay.
So I just want y'all to know that. That is illegal, okay? Illegal. I don't care how good the advertisement, and I think you should probably do it as a side hustle.
I bet you lie.
You was definitely about to catch y'all for the okie doke. Okay?
Nah, because I seen where you seen the couple that got arrested because they were trying to buy a car, and the police was telling them, said, it's in somebody else's name, it's illegal. He was saying, like, if it was in your name or the business, then it's not illegal because they were saying they didn't know it was illegal.
It's illegal.
Well, listen, they say I got a whole CPN package right now, car and apartment package.
Dang. You got to switch some shits up every so often, though, ain't it?
Damn it, man. Okay, look, man, let's get into it, man. Y'all already know, man. So the word on the street is Muwop told that Lil Durk paid him to kill FBG Duck. That's the word on the street. We finna get into it. Make sure y'all hit that like button, man. Hit that like button. Hit that like button.
And you the reason why I told you that video is just like society now. Because you were this shit with content when you know it's food.
But I'm saying this the people that, you know, motherfuckers look up to. Like, wait, he said it. Like, listen, motherfucker in my comment section told me, you know, butter talk to the police. How you know it ain't real? He could be telling the truth. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So,
man, you know, FBI butter telling the truth, the world was definitely in.
So, you know, people believe this shit. So, okay, look. Lil Durk allegedly told, Muwop allegedly told that Lil Durk paid him to kill FBG Duck. Let's check it out, man.
That shit ridiculous. At this point, you gotta laugh at that shit.
Muwop told the police that Lil Durk paid him to kill FBG Duck, and Lil Durk ain't locked up.
Who said that? Who said that? Who said that?
Yeah, I said the same thing. Check it out.
Everybody arrest video coming out from when they got arrested for this Duck case. Y'all ain't seen Muwop since he murders, have y'all? Y'all wanna know why? They got locked up with the FBI biggest informant, gang. They got snatched a private jet. Vaughn did. Well, how the f is these paying for a jet? Who got a jet fueled up and got these boys flew to Chicago in 5 hours? Who got money to do that? They called Durk, hey, you get them guys here, we're gonna come get you with them. Cause just like the evidence they had on Shorty, then they had on Durk too. You just paid to get your...
You on mute. I'm gonna need for you to get that together.
I'm sorry, y'all. Now, before I go any farther, Mickey, can you explain to them why that's a lie about Durk sent Muwop them back?
Everything he just said is a lie. Like, everything he just said. Okay, let me just start from here. First and foremost, okay, none of the O-Block 6 arrest video is out. None of them. The video of C-Thang that's floating around is not from his arrest for the LBG Duck murder, okay? That's from a 2020 arrest. Remember, everybody got arrested in October 2021. So that is not the video. So none of their arrest videos is out. Second, C-Murder was not with Muwop when he was arrested at the airport. And thirdly, Durk or nobody else threw up no jet to send back to Chicago because Muwop never left Chicago. They filmed a video the night before and it ran late. So that morning he was going to go back on tour. So the plane never even took off the ground from Chicago when he got picked up. So he was already in Chicago at the airport when he got arrested. And C-Murder was not there. Actually, according to Street News TV, he was arrested in O-Block with the rest of them, but Muwop was by himself when he got arrested. And that's factual. Facts. I don't know what's going on with music and his mute, but yeah. Any questions to that? That man, that FBI butter just be talking.
Right. Facts.
Your brother killed. How you not in jail?
We ain't talking about this. This ain't happening in our face, huh?
Guess what? Bugs Bunny back again.
The rapper got the gun, and I know what I'm doing with this. Bro, I quit. No, seriously, though. They say Shorty flat out told they ass, like, man, she looked dirt, told me to do that. And he paid me to do it. Showing receipts.
Now, he said Shorty flat out lied, man. Well, he ain't lie. He say Shorty flat out told him and said, Lil Durk paid me to do that shit.
Like, this gave me real money to get this man gone. A lot of
go ahead.
So, if he made a statement and told all this, why did he end up at trial?
Facts.
You would think that would definitely be room for a deal, right?
Facts. And then another thing. People saying, well, how you know that butter is not telling the truth, because Muwop just let him know about the acquittal Muwop just put in, basically saying it's not enough evidence to prove that I did it. It's lack of evidence, and I want to be released. So why would he tell the police that Durk paid him to kill Duck if he's putting in a motion saying it's not enough evidence to prove that I did this?
Right, and they put in a verbal motion during trial. So for those who like, oh well, you know, he got convicted now, why he doing all this? He put it in during trial. They just never ruled on it. So his legal team came back and put in a written motion for the same thing, and they outline, and y'all, that video is available on my page, and of course the paperwork is out too. Like, it says that Muwop never provided a statement, never provided any information at all. So I'm not really sure who he's talking to for all of this. And now, mind you, for those who have been following the O-Block case, the ones who do have a statement, guess what? We know they have a statement because their legal teams put in a motion to suppress said statement.
Facts. Hey, man, we got 58 people in here. Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button for me, please. And subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. Listen. This ain't where it ended at. Butter really popped it. It's more. Butter popped it.
A lot of money, right? Why is this man out of jail, gang?
Man, come on, man. At this point, they should all know that Butter is just saying whatever at this point, because. And that's facts. Y'all should know that Butter saying whatever at this point, but that ain't where it stopped at.
It get worse.
Butter said that Muwop was shot in the neck when they killed LBG Duck. No lie. On Phone No Grade. Check it out.
You got
to
unmute them.
The female that she's with, she hit two of them. Muwop bullet.
Damn.
Hit his neck. Muwop bullet.
Damn.
Hit his neck. Right.
Damn.
Was in the wall. Zell bullet. hit his head, he dropped his brick. These niggas told him they sold. And they did an interview on top of the fucking murder cop. You stupid fucks.
What about the picture that
take
went
me to jail? Give me so, the cups.
Yo, butter. What about the picture that went viral with Muwop wearing with the duck sneakers?
That's clown shit. If with the same Draco y'all use. Get a feds day evidence.
That's the same.
Homicide can't solve it. But the feds can, right? Yeah. We talking real business. I'm a real street nigga.
Nah, that wasn't the same. That wasn't the same. That's in the document. Wait. Nigga, spice, is that in public spice. Documents that's the same? That
was it
the
same. Is.
The nigga said, "Oh, Shondell Gregory." He put this on Shondell Gregory. Now, hold on, Mickey. Now, we're going to go down to three things he said, and then we're going to break it down. He said, one, that Muwop told them people that Durk paid him to kill Duck. We already explained that. That's cap. Two, he said Muwop was shot in the neck. So let's just say if Muwop was shot in the neck, why they didn't use that for evidence in court? Why was that using evidence in court? And then he said that was the same Draco they used in their videos to kill FBG Duck. Well, where does it says that in the paperwork? Pop your shit, man. Because at this point.
Well, I mean, in a nutshell, Muwop family confirmed he ain't never been shot ever at all. Let's just start there. But even if you didn't have a way to like reach out to somebody close to him, if you look at his photos before the murder and after the murder, nothing changes to his neck. Even if he was grazed, you will have a mark or something on it. It's nothing on his neck. Now, paperwork wise, if you read the government proffer, they do say that the female victim did shoot back at those who got out the first car. And then somebody in the second car shot her, right? Now, if you go down a little further in that same proffer, the witness who was the friend of Kenny Max, right, said that Kenny Max told him a story that the girl shot at him and made him drop his gun, right? Now, why they knew the witness had to be telling the truth at the time is because no one knew that the female actually shot back, right? But what FBI Butter is doing is mixing up the two situations. So the fact of that story is that, yes, the female supposedly shot back. They didn't say in the paperwork she hit anybody, but that she shot back, right? The lie in that story is that he's taking Kenny Mac's little story that he told the witness and mixing it together. So, yeah. That's that.
So, for sure, that right there let us know that is no proof that Muwop told on Durk. It can't be because Muwop saying he's innocent.
Yeah, that makes just, some sense.
Right, he just filed for acquittal. It's no proof that Muwop was shot in his neck. Muwop family say Muwop never been shot. It's not in the paperwork. It's no evidence. It's no proof that the Draco that they were showing in their videos.
And that was another thing, because to my understanding, they didn't even find none of the weapons.
The murder weapons.
I believe, what's his name? Lowe's, they searched his house something and found, but the weapon that was found wasn't even the weapon. So how would you know what weapon was used when, you know what I'm saying? They never found nothing.
Facts. So at this point, it's just safe to say that Butter is just going, you know, on these interviews and just telling good stories. It's safe to say.
That's it. I mean, I will say this, you know, I despise that man with all of me, but I got to give it to him. He has learned how to manipulate his social media shit, and he has learned how to make it go up for him. And all it took was for him to testify against six people that he don't know. And now he on all platforms, lying, just because he's entertaining. Like
facts. Hey,
shout out to him for that shit.
It's 73 people in here, man. Could y'all please hit that like button? Hit that like button. And subscribe to our channel if you're not subscribed. So there you have it, man. FBI Butter, he capped. Muwop ain't told on nobody. It ain't no evidence showing that Muwop was shot or the guns that was used in Muwop videos is actually the murder weapon. Mm-mm. So we gonna go down to Bricc Baby.
Bricc, one last thing.
Go ahead.
About Muwop as far as the acquittal, because somebody hit me up earlier saying, well, his acquittal was denied. No, it's not. The timeline, like the news gave, when the verdict first came out, they gave a timeline. So the motions from all defendants had to be in by March 16th. So that deadline has passed, okay? And just FYI, because a lot of people say, well, no other defendants filed a motion. Well, a few of them had verbal motions put in before the trial ended, and I went over it in my video. Y'all check it out. And also, what happens when you have multiple defendants on a case? If one defendant files a motion, they can all piggyback off of that without filing a motion. Unless the defense for that defendant files a motion saying, no, we're not going with that motion. So although, for example, Muwop filed the written acquittal, they all can piggyback off of that too, okay? So the government has until April 16th to do replies to all the motions on why it shouldn't be acquittal, whatever, whatever. Once they do theirs on April 16th, then the judge will make a decision. So as of now, okay, the motion is still pending. It never was denied. Like I told y'all, the mistrial that included me just got denied a couple days ago. So it takes time. It's not something that happens. We may stop thinking about it and all of a sudden a decision is out. So that's just, I just want to add that because there's a lot of misinformation with that. But yep, there you go. At this point, I'm about to be the fucking Muwop whisper in a minute.
Hey, you might as well, you know what I'm saying? You might as well.
I ain't never talked to that man a day in my life.
You might as well be Muwop whisper, goddammit. His representative. Now, okay. We went from Muwop telling on Lil Durk to Bricc Baby and Lil Durk going to jail. Might be going to jail.
It was the most epic shit this week, though. I ain't going to lie. This is it.
Salute to Poetic Flocko, man. For the people that don't know, Poetic Flocko dropped a video that went viral that ruffed a lot of people's feathers. And what he did was he put together a timeline between the beef between Quando Rondo, Lil Durk, Bricc Baby, and Quando Rondo's best friend, Lil Pab, getting shot and killed. Now, y'all boy Poetic Flocko said, Quando Rondo exposed information that could send Lil Durk and Bricc Baby to jail. Now, for the people that don't know, y'all know that Lil Pab was shot and killed in LA. Now, when he was shot and killed, it was a lot of whispering going on. A lot of people felt like that was dirt work. And dirt,
the internet,
you know, the internet be interneting.
Okay.
A lot of people felt like Dirt used Bricc Baby, because if you don't know, Bricc Baby been cool with Dirt since like 2018 type it. For real. Mm-hmm. Like, Bricc Baby, for him to live in LA and from LA, that nigga has been in Chicago and Atlanta for a while. You know what I'm saying? So Bricc Baby is like this with Dirt. And the internet felt like Dirt used Bricc Baby and his connect to take out Lil Pal, which is Quando Rondo homie. Now, Quando Rondo did address this situation. And Quando Rondo said that in the song, that Dirk had nothing to do with Lil Pab death. He said that Lil Pab ran off on a plug, and that's why he was killed. But then Quando Rondo just dropped the song insinuating off the new album or the EP with him and Lil Tim, basically saying that, you know what I'm saying, he was on the phone with Bricc Baby. He had to laugh and all this shit here, and that the score is 1-1 and he trying to run it up to 2-1. And people like, damn, well, Lil Pab got killed. King Von got killed. So that's like 1-1. And Quando said he trying to run it up 2-1. And he's saying, y'all talking about it's killers in California, but we need to show them what Savannah on. If y'all don't know, Lil Durk dropped a song called Same Side. And he say he hate when people say Cali weird, you know what I'm saying? Because Cali got real killers.
And y'all Quando, is crazy.
Hey, they got hey, salute to Poetic Flacco. And Quando Rondo said, y'all talking about Cali got real killers. Y'all need to know what Savannah on type shit. So he put all these together. Then it was 100. They said it was 100,000 on Quando Rondo head. And then it went up to 1 million. And Quando Rondo even said that it's 100. No, it's 1 million on his head, right? Poetic Flacco, when I tell you, he put it together and did what he did. But a lot of people was upset, even Brick Baby. But let's check it out.
Let me continue. Hold on. I got to set the foundation. Go ahead. One of those people that was thrilled with this video is Music 101. Music 101 called my ass soon as this shit hit. And he's like, yo, did you see the video? I'm like, no. Oh, shit, that shit. I'm like, bro, you know that shit ain't for real, right? But Music 101, hey, definitely was going with it.
Nah, because look, when I did the video on Kayla B and Pungy, this issue came up about Quando Rondo, Lil Pab getting killed in LA and all this stuff. And they was talking like it was they brought it back up. So that's when, you know what I'm saying, somebody shared a light, one of the Quando Rondo people. Shared it like that. Quando Rondo already talked about this situation. Durk had nothing to do with it. So they sent me the song. In the song, he was saying that Lil Pab ran off on the plug, like, you know what I'm saying, from LA. So then when he put all this shit together, I knew it was going to go crazy because I'm like, this is what the internet think anyway. So for him to just put this shit together like that, I knew it was going to go crazy. So
hey, first quarter.
First motherfucking quarter. You right, too. First quarter. That's why, hey, I pity, but you know what I said? Hey, you know what I said?
What is this Terrence guy? What up? We ain't even an hour in. Before we continue, because Terrence, who is lying, please? Now, we can't hold the show up all night. Who is lying? Because I feel like he has a grievance.
I'm telling you, he said on phone now.
Oh, Lord, continue.
Hey, you know, some people be slow, man. Like, some people comfort, like, for a good example, I forgot what rapper said this. He said, but when we was in school, it was a separation. You had the people that was slow and ADHD, they was in the portables. The regular people was in the school, at the main school. They kept us separated. These people graduate, now we're all mixed together. We don't know who's slow, ADHD, or not.
The certificates with the diplomas, huh?
Right. You know what I'm saying? The certificates is with the diplomas. All us mixed together now. So you be having people that ain't got them all mixing with the people that got them all, and you get it like this right here. You know what I'm saying? Talking about lying on phone them and shit like this. And I just broke it down. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this shit crazy to me. But, hey. So I'm gonna just let it play a little
bit. Yeah, we're gonna keep going.
Yeah, we're gonna skim through this video so we could get to the good it. You hear me?
LA is the murder of Quando Rondo's best friend Lil Pop.
New details tonight in a deadly shooting near the Beverly Center. We've learned the victim is a friend of rapper Quando Rondo. The Atlanta-based performer shared this picture on Instagram today. According to the LAPD, the victim was ambushed by three men while getting gas on Friday. Video from the scene appears to show Quando Rondo distraught while first responders moved the body. So far, no arrests have been made.
The murder is still unsolved. There's no suspect the police has released for this murder. However, the fans has automatically given Lil Durk credit for this murder due to the history between Lil Durk, King Von, and Quando Rondo, obviously because Quando Rondo and his brother Lil Tim is responsible for the death of King Von. So people automatically assume that Quando Rondo and his best friend getting hit up was a hit called by Lil Durk. Lil Durk wasn't in LA at the time of Lil Pop's death, so the fan theory is Lil Durk solicited the help of a reputable LA gang member, Bricc Baby, to take out Lil Pop and Quando Rondo. Fans will claim that Lil Durk will pay Bricc Baby, who can be seen here, photographed with Lil Durk in LA a month before Lil Pop's murder. Fans will claim that Lil Durk would pay Bricc Baby $100,000 for the hit. Bricc Baby is a Rolling 60 neighborhood crip, and Quando Rondo is too. So the theory itself appeared to be far-fetched. That's until Quando Rondo took to his Instagram to denounce the neighborhood card and drop his flag. Quando Rondo will state that he's dropping his flag because there's no loyalty in this, and the neighborhoods didn't have his back how he thought they would have his back. But the rumors that Lil Durk paid Bricc Baby $100,000 for the hit on Lil Pop and Quando Rondo really grew some legs and even wings when Bricc Baby dropped his single Not Enough. Bricc Baby will respond back to the fan theory of him receiving $100,000 for the hit on Lil Pop and Quando Rondo. See, Bricc will respond back with some really questionable lyrics. He was ducking, trying to hide, and he inside a blunt. We dropped $100 on your guy, go scrape your pile up. Your chance to flip your brand new charger, trying to follow up. We charged a quarter for a pack, $100's not enough. The last nigga we turned the pack, we got $1 million plus. Yeah, the way Boogie do his thing, he need $1 million plus. TS, how about walk him down, Jack, I'm chop him up. He wanna smoke that chopper, hit his lungs, he cough it up every time you in my city, guap it up. Let's slow down and dissect these lyrics real quick. This could be interpreted as we put $100,000 on our last op. He was just a local California dude. If Lil Durk wanted me and my immediate circle to conduct a hit on Lil Pop and Quando, it would have cost at least $250,000. $100K is not enough for me and my immediate circle to do the hit. So the speculation we got $100,000 for the hit on Lil Pop and Quando.
What part you miss?
I didn't see this part. He broke down. He's been serving in the song. And y'all wonder why the feds doing that shit. The fuck? I didn't see that part.
Now, what I tell you, Poetic Flago, he did his big one. For him to be cool with Bricc Baby, he did his big one, y'all. Even me. When I, like, once I seen Poetic Flago, because I've been heard the Quando Rondo song. But y'all know me. I say I'm not finna drop this song or speak on this song until somebody big do it and it go viral. So when Flacco did it, that's when I did my video. But I clearly let it be known. I don't think that Quando Rondo is telling the truth. I think Quando Rondo just saying this shit for entertainment purposes only. He already said that Durk had nothing to do with this. But one thing I didn't do, I didn't break down Bricc Baby's song. You know what I'm saying? Because, hey. That's
crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
That's fucking crazy.
It's entertainment purpose. I think Bricc Baby just hollering. But hey, it hit everything on the head. You hear me? So I said I wasn't doing it. I wasn't finna break down Bricc Baby song. See, Quando Rondo, I broke down Quando shit because Quando already said it himself that hey, Durk ain't had nothing to do with it. Then you come back with a song basically insinuating Durk. So it's like that could be arguable. But Bricc Baby song, I couldn't do it.
You got to love the internet. That shit made me stop eating my pizza.
Hey, you know what I'm saying?
I know. It's not true. It was actually $1 million.
The way Boogie do his thing, you need $1 million plus. TS, how about walk him down? Jack, I'm chop him up.
Then the dudes he named were hypothetically the dudes who, if Bricc Baby did have an issue with anybody, those would be the dudes he would call because they do great work, allegedly. Right? I don't know.
So then that boy... What he did was what was crazy to me. He pointed out his killers. He said, do great work. Bitch need $1 million. Like, that, you know what I'm saying? So I couldn't do a reaction to your boy video. But Bricc Baby responded to this situation. Bricc Baby wasn't happy. Bricc Baby was mad as a bitch. Now, a lot of people feel like this is all a play. A lot of people feel like Bricc Baby gave Flacco the okay to do this and that all this is a play. But y'all tell me what you think. Hold on. Because Bricc Baby 38, Bricc Baby said he going to put Kill Squad in the street if...
I ain't going to lie. ain't believing that Brick Bay was that man. I ain't gonna lie.
You don't think Brick Bay was that man?
He ain't get on live in his car running Flocko down or nothing. I don't believe it.
Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button, man. 63 people here, hit that like button. Now, I ain't gonna lie. I don't really watch Brick Baby to tell what's he like, you know what I'm saying, how he usually act. So I don't know, but I will say a lot of people said that Brick Baby is in with this. And I said in my video, I just feel like, oh, this is a play. I feel like Quando made this song because he know right now he need the funds. He need to go viral. He know Durk ain't had nothing to do with it. He know Brick Baby ain't had nothing to do with it.
Hold on, you calling Quando Rondo broke?
I ain't saying he broke, but I'm saying like, shit, he fighting the feds. Nigga need everything right now. You know what I'm saying? You heard what he said. I ain't getting nobody no money. Bitch, can't nobody get nothing. Like,
it's
he needs
a timing that Brick Baby started that Kill Squad shit. It's just like,
hey, he most definitely started something with Kill Squad. He most definitely started something. They say, and he said he just made that up. He said he made it up now. He said it is no such thing as a real Kill Squad. He just made that up.
But some nigga do some shit and say Kill Squad.
Oh man, in the name of Brick Baby. Then Adam gonna have to burn that bitch out. In the name of Brick Baby. So this right here is Brick Baby responding to Poetic Flocko dropping that incriminating video saying that Quando Rondo released information that may get Brick Baby and Lil Durk locked up. Check it out.
Hey, cop ass Flocko, cuz. What made your punk ass go post a motherfucking video of me, nigga, do run content of me and Quando Rondo, nigga, on the dead homies with all the shit that I got going on right now. All the shit that you see a nigga going through, cuz nigga supposed to be my partner and running content on some murder shit? Try to put a nigga in the middle, like, come on, gang. Like, nigga, now when a nigga, listen, run that content one more time, nigga. Kill Squad gonna be in the streets on your ass. You gonna be the first motherfucking example, nigga. Look, nigga, I'ma holler at you when I get back to L.A. too, nigga.
Hey, that's what gave it away. I ain't gonna lie. That's what gave it away to me. When he said, run that content one more time, the kill, I said, oh, shit. He gave it away.
So, hey, after that, Brick Baby actually went back to L.A. And it's supposed to be in a situation where Poetic Flocko supposed to pull it up to Brick Baby's show. And Brick Baby's Poetic Flocko say he understand he will fight Brick Baby because Brick Baby wanted to fight.
Mm-hmm.
So he said he understood, right?
Right.
So when it came to him supposed to pull up on Brick Baby's show on No Jumper, he never showed up. Poetic Flocko never showed up.
Right.
So Brick Baby pulled up to a Poetic Flocko segment and tried to get it popping.
Right.
Well, supposed to be in trying to get it popping. But a lot mm-hmm. of people feel like it's staged. Y'all let me know, man. Is this shit staged or what?
Definitely staged.
Now, I ain't gonna lie. What made me feel like it was staged when Poetic Flocko jumped up? Like, come on now. You already let it be known that you didn't want to fight Brick Baby.
Listen, so, when Brick Baby crashed out on that episode, now that felt more real, okay? Because everybody was looking like, oh, shit, what the fuck? Like, even the gangsters on the couch was like, hold on, what the fuck going on? And nothing right. even went on like that. So, for this, for Flocko, come on.
Hold on, let me pull it up.
And then you paid attention, Shark gets up too quick. He missed.
He was already on it. And Brick Baby is Shark only. So, you know what I'm saying? That's what really, like, I ain't gonna lie. That's what I said. Quick. Yeah, that's what I said. I said, what threw me off was...
And then before you play, now, follow the timeline, okay? The low get dropped. Brick Baby crash out, right? Remo and Flocko said OTL trying to run up on him over Durk. Then right. Poetic Flocko dropped this viral video of Brick Baby and Lil Durk.
Right.
And then now Brick Baby creates Kill Squad. Now him and Flocko fight, you know, come on. You got to follow the whole storyline.
Now look, before we get into this though, and this is why I really feel like it's a play, because that ain't stopped up. Shit, Brick Baby now is into it with another dude who he finna fight off No Jumper. So this shit look like a Brick Baby fight off type.
Let me
shit.
Find out No Jumper about to create celebrity boxing matches or some shit. Like this something for something.
For real.
And then hold on, we gonna
go ahead.
Hold on, because let's do this first, and then I got something to add to it that really made it like this shit is all like for promo.
Mm-hmm.
Should I say it now? I don't know if I should wait to say it.
Hey, don't wait, goddamn, because hey.
Well, you saw Brick Baby and Quando Rondo was on FaceTime with Remo, right?
Right.
I believe Quando Rondo is doing a No Jumper interview.
You think Quando Rondo don't know? That'd be big too. Okay, so look, and damn, I'm tripping because I forgot to do a video on that. That shit would have went crazy. But okay, so look. Now I will say this though. I will say this. Brick Baby did say in his No Tune interview that Quando Rondo called him when the beef was going down. And he told Brick Baby, listen. I understand that Durk is your partner. He say, but you is one of the guys. You supposed to be rolling 60 on Crip. You know what I'm saying? Neighborhood. He told, Brick Baby said, Quando told him, if Durk them catch me, let them catch me. If they basically like, if they kill me, let them kill me. But you just don't set me up. And Brick Baby say he respected it and he got out the beef. So, Brick Baby is saying that Quando called him and told him, look, man, listen, I understand that's your dog, but you just stay out of this shit. If them niggas catch me and kill me, like, let them niggas do that. Like, you don't have no part of this because we are part of the same gang. For real. So Brick Baby said he stayed out of it. He said, now, if something go down and he's with Durk, he riding with Durk. Because the policy is you ride with who you came with. He said this in the interview. So he is cordial with Quando Rondo since the King Von Lil Pab death. He is cordial. It's like it ain't no real beef for real. He said he cordial.
Mm.
So, hey, it might be a Quando Rondo interview coming.
Oh, it's definitely a Quando Rondo interview coming. And to be honest, it might be where Brick Baby is the one that goes out there to do the interview.
Gotta be hard.
Quando Rondo is definitely not coming to No Jumper. He can't.
Right. And I ain't gonna lie to him. I wouldn't even allow Brick Baby to come. I'll pop his as soon as Brick Baby show up, his ass get foot shot. Like at this point, no. Brick Baby.
They got too much going on. He's not gonna be doing all that.
Right. But no, like,
I have heard they like Fort Knox down that motherfucker. At that damn, he learned well from NBA.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. It wouldn't even be safe for Brick Baby to go down there just because of the internet.
But I'm pretty sure that type of interview, it probably definitely Adam that actually pulls up
for sure.
Or Remo or one, you know, if they really pull up. But yeah, hey, I remember listening to them fucking wiretaps, and his homeboys was even like, hey, I'm in a different car. Okay, stand there. I'm about to pull up.
Right. And see, a lot of people don't know that, and I spoke about this before we played the clip of Brick Baby running up on Poetic Flocko. A lot of people don't know that Quando Rondo been having shit going on before this little King Bump.
Sure. I keep saying that.
Yeah, like they already, his clique already been indicted before he even really started being famous for rap and shit. Like they was already got indicted. He just wasn't involved.
See, like I heard of him because, you know, our states are right here way before I even like did the blogging thing. Like, so, yeah.
Yeah, like this shit, you know what I'm saying? This shit, like, and see, that's the thing too. Like, y'all be thinking like Quando, listen, I was not to toot my own horn, but I was one of the first ones to post Quando Rondo. I posted Quando. I had a lot of people don't know. I had a page that promoted up and coming rappers. Like, I had 20,000 followers on Instagram. I was promoting up and coming rappers. And somebody sent me Quando Rondo when he first got out of jail. He was beating on cars and shit. And he was talking about some chick that broke his heart and shit. And I posted that bitch. And I say, he gonna pop. Him and the niggas, the R&B nigga from Jacksonville. What's his name? I be forgetting his name. I give you the real baby girl. YK Osiris.
Yeah.
I posted YK Osiris. My cousin from Jacksonville, he turned me on to YK before YK was popping. You know what I'm saying? And hey, it been going down, you know what I'm saying, where Quando at though. You know what I'm saying? Like like that shit really been like that. And when y'all hear songs about him rapping about Lil Tim, he's not talking about King Von. Like, no, he's been saying, yeah, for sure. Like, he been saying Tim before King Von.
Like, yeah, that's why I was like, and like I said, I heard whispers before, but then when I sat on 5 hours at that motherfucking hearing and I listened to them wiretaps and shit, I tell you now, every time my mind don't never go to the King Von situation no more. I don't never go there.
Right. But see, but that just the internet, like, because motherfuckers don't know, like, they just be picking up, you know what I'm saying, when the first people get famous and shit.
Quando is really, and I'm going to say this just from what I was hearing on the wire, Quando is really the head of something. I ain't about to say he a head of no gang or no head. He head of something. He the man of something. It's the gang of the show.
Right. And another thing, how deep this shit is. One of his partners got killed. The news interviewed the jit that got killed, auntie. And she basically told him, look, man, she wrecked the neighborhood. Like, listen, this shit hit what it is. Like, hey, we ain't tripping. You know what I'm saying? Like, the auntie of the jit that got killed basically, like, look, we ain't tripping. Like, justice gonna be served. Like, that's like, that's how that shit is. Like, it's a family type. She was like, nah, Quando them ain't no gang, because I forgot the actual name of their shit. Mm-hmm. But the news anchor was like, do you feel bad that your nephew died in the gang war? And she like, nah, this family, like, you know, this ain't no gang, this family, like, we all.
Yeah, the news tapping in with them, like, Savannah ain't but so big. So, like, right. It's not like a big place. But the news, I'm telling you, when I was sitting down in Caribbean, remember we had a power outage during the hearing. Hey, the news people was tapping in with the family. They, everybody know each other down that mug.
Facts. 5 more people hit that like button, man. Hit that like button. Let's get it to it, man. So this right here is Bricc, baby.
Oh, yeah. So, when we get done, remind me to mention something about Quando, but it's off of this, so just remind me.
All right. So this right here is Bricc, baby, supposed to be running up on Flocko. Y'all get in the comments and let me know, do you think this shit is real or is scripted, man? Mind you, Flocko ain't on that. Flocko ain't on that. But he looked like he was on that today.
This is some internet shit, bro. What?
This is too much.
This is some internet shit, bro. What?
Where's Flocko going? Like, that's like, where's Flocko? Where's Flocko going?
He didn't stay in character. He was laughing. Okay. Listen, that shit was definitely staged. Okay.
And you mean to tell me Brit Baby let Sharp stop him from? And this how I know it was staged, because when Brit Baby was going through it that first time with that dude that say he pulled up to no jumper and it was going down, Sharp made it clear. Bitch, I'm staying out the way when the beef is on. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this, like, nigga, I'm not trying to stop no nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? He made it clear.
Hey, and old girl probably ain't read the group chat. That's why she was looking like, what the fuck is happening?
Fucked up. But I'm finna finish the rest of the clip.
Stay back here. You can stay back here. Stay
here. Yeah, stay. I didn't realize she made the wrong one.
Stay in here.
We're not doing this again.
John, come on.
Come on.
Hey, John, come on, bro.
I ain't here. Oh, now time doing this shit.
Now time.
Oh, this girl, I gotta eat something.
He said I gotta eat something.
Bro, cat, like, what the fuck? Hey, man, listen, man. It's no jumper, man.
Man, listen. This nigga here. He said he gotta eat something.
Better acting coach, man.
This nigga ain't did shit for real. What do you gotta eat for? Like, come on, man.
Man, but he's funny though. He's funny.
I'm gonna play a little bit more, man. Real quick.
Man, listen. I don't. Feel me? Bro,
dude, I can't believe we're doing this shit again. I thought we'd gotten to the point where we're not fighting on the news or calling fights out.
Bro,
we talked about
this. We literally talked about this. But we had an agreement, though. You feel me? It wasn't supposed to be here.
I'm a call suspect.
No.
So he said we had an agreement. He wasn't supposed to be. It wasn't supposed to be here. Now, for the people that don't know that, Brick Baby told Poetic Flacco that we gotta fight. It ain't no if and but. Only way we could be cool again if we fight. So Flacco say yes, he will fight Brick Baby, but they need gloves though. They gotta have boxing gloves, and he with it.
Pause. Was this before or after Brick Baby show?
What Brick Baby show? This is after the Brick Baby show, because Poetic Flacco was supposed to pull it up to the Brick Baby show.
Did you watch that and listen to what Brick Baby said, though?
I ain't gonna lie. I don't think I did.
He basically said he ain't taking Flacco serious. Like, he basically was downplaying the shit type thing.
I just seen the clip where he was saying that Flacco didn't show up. He was like, Flacco supposed to be here. We supposed to get
they
it on type shit.
Videos, but...
Hold on. Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button, man. Appreciate everybody that's tapping in. Y'all make sure y'all subscribe to the channel, turn our post notification bells, hit the super chats, cash outs. You know what I'm saying? If y'all feeling generous.
My light bill, dude. Help me out, y'all.
I'm trying.
I ain't sipping on nothing. I got an early flight, so I ain't sipping on nothing, boo. Shout out to the whole Truth team. Everybody pulling up. Zari, I did not know you ain't having ranch. I just gave you one. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. She pulls up all the time. I see her commenting all the time, and she wasn't even a mod.
It's time to redefine.
Nah, for sure. Hold on.
Now, I could have been mixing shit up. I could have sworn Brick Baby was like, that's his brother. Like, that's like, you know, it wasn't nothing. That's how, like, it got to be staged.
I know. I had watched the clip of it that, you know what I'm saying, I guess they posted, and he was just basically saying, like, he ain't really show no animosity for real.
Yeah, that's on, like, that shit gotta be staged.
But he was just like, Flacco supposed to be here today.
We all cool.
Flacco just been doing all kind of bullshit.
Flacco got a cut. Flacco got to come out at what me face to face for a second.
What happened so last night with Flacco? Him talking about the bounce.
Don't ask for no
bounce on the ounce.
I'm gonna be hella disappointed if I see Bricc ask Flacco for a fade.
I ain't go ask Flacco for nothing. I'm gonna just get off.
Hey,
don't do it, Bricc.
The man has spoke.
Don't do it.
I mean,
Flacco.
He put himself in the situation, bro. He put himself in the situation. So he doing fair shit. Now he doing fair shit to his partner.
I'm gonna tell my
he's not only doing fair shit.
You can bring the gloves. You can bring the gloves. Flacco told me bring the gloves, please.
You don't think he protecting himself?
Oh, he said please.
Flacco said please.
Oh, so he ready for this?
He's not. No, Flacco is not protecting his sexuality. Because the here we go again show, Flacco, he must engage in Dejan Paul's.
I just want to say this.
Okay, I mixed up said in Ash video. Okay, my bad.
I just want to say this. This dude right here, he was just on Bricc Baby live today with the same thing. I don't know who he is. He had the same thing on. But Bricc Baby had this on when he crashed out. Am I tripping or like how do y'all shuffle?
Who is that? A no jumper thing? That's like somebody's actual like item that they were selling. I can't remember who it was.
Okay. I'm finna say Sharon Hood, little ski mask is crazy. Like,
yeah, you know who shit is it? Is it no joke? Somebody is like, that's their item. I just can't think of who it is. It might be no jumper, actually.
Okay. So, for the people that, you know what I'm saying, Flacco dropped the video and Bricc Baby.
Did you catch the Flacco response to all the backlash and he spoke in third person?
I ain't watch it, but I seen what he said. Let me see.
Flacco like, said, now that's some shit I would have did. Fucking backlash.
Flacco
now that
said,
was funny. That video was funny. He's talking about this weird ass Flacco. That's how you know this is entertainment, man, because that was funny when he came and dropped that fucking response. Wow, listen. Ooh, Bricc Baby, now you really got to catch the fade with Flacco, because you said, run that content one more time. The Kill Squad is coming. And when Flacco posted his third-person video, he put the fucking original video.
He talked. He basically did a recap.
Oh shit! Now he did. I just thought about that. He did it.
He basically did a recap.
He definitely posted it again.
Okay, so I want to say this too, because a lot of people, I see a lot of people been showing a lot of hate with Bricc Baby, No Jumper, and Flacco. And I understand both ways, but let's be real here, though. Let's be real. Now, it's a lot of people saying that Bricc Baby, Flacco, No Jumper, they goofies for staging content. Know what I'm saying? But I want to say this, though. YouTube is for entertainment purposes only, bro. Like, they're staging content, but it's just for the entertainment. So we looking at it like it might be real, but they looking at it as a show. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like, y'all got to understand, like,
yeah,
this,
it's
like,
it's the soap operas.
Right. So
it's like Young and the Restless. It got to continue on. The comments threw you off.
Nah, I was reading some motherfucker had a long
That's what I'm saying. That's because I was like, he must have just seen the comment. I was just
I see motherfuckers say, I'll be back to check shit out when he get real. He's dropping. He say body's dropping.
That's what made me say the
real shit in real life. I come for some street music, not General Hospital.
Why you all here playing General Hospital instead of street music?
Hey, so I don't know. So is he saying he looking for music, not
He said you doing this soft content, that soft bug content.
He want people dead and shit. He want to see people dead.
He can't use it, but
this shit here.
Hey. I'm gonna say this though. To be honest, now I think some of the shit go too far, But some of it be funny. Like this, I feel is funny. Minus the video now, because if I wouldn't have been at that hearing, right, and heard what I heard, that, you know, I probably would have looked at the video a little more seriously, but because I knew it was cap, I just, like, you know, it's funny, but, like, minus the video and just the whole, I like how it's kind of creating this storyline is going, in my opinion, I think it's going to end with a Quando Rondo interview, but, yeah, some of it be going a little too far. I mean, at this point, that's what the internet want. They are entertained. They want to see what's happening next, you know, like, you know?
Right.
It's first quarter, shit.
Right. Yeah, and see, you know, Mickey done said it two times, it's first quarter. For the people that don't know, it is first quarter, meaning, like, when it comes to rap, entertainment, business, and shit like that, it go by quarters. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's four quarters, and the four quarters divide the year up. So it might be January to such and such may be the first quarter. So in the first quarter, and quarters, people is trying to get it popping, like get their channel, get their business. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
First quarter don't have no major holidays. You know what I'm saying? You said, right. Hey, I'm learning this now. Last year, I ain't know nothing about no quarter. I know about that shit this year. Okay, so hey.
And I learned the quarters from music. It's the same way in the music business. The first quarter, they be wanting you to, you know, whatever you got to do to go viral, bitch, you need to go viral, because that going to dictate how the rest of the year go
for now you. Now, let me ask you this. Which one was bigger? The Academics one or Flocko one?
Flocko put murders on motherfuckers.
He said, listen, look, what killed me was he said, hey, nobody's been arrested and there's no suspect, but here goes some suspect.
Right. Right, nobody been arrested for this shit. No suspects, but hey, go the suspects. These bitches might go to jail.
That's basically what he said. Reputable game, I was like, and then he even had the picture from them on. Now listen, and I will say this, just another thing. Just think about it. According to Quando Rondo, that truck was not planned far in advance like that for them to have to set this shit up in the studio a month before.
Right,
it's crazy.
Facts. And I do want to say this too, just to you know what I'm saying, shed some light on the situation for the people that feel like Brick baby them, or you know what I'm saying, the Rolling Crips or whatever the case may be, or Durk could have had did some, like Brick baby, he spoke on the Quando Rondo situation in the Real Tune interview, and he said if Durk sent the hit, why would somebody reach past Durk and shoot his homie? Quando. I mean, yeah, reach past Quando and shoot Lil Pab. Like, it ain't no killer.
Get on, Durk is crazy.
Hey, you know, I be getting these motherfuckers. But he made sense. Why would a person reach past Quando and shoot Durk? You feel what I'm saying? Like, that right there let you know that it wasn't for Quando.
If he ran off on a plug, why the fuck did he go to L.A.?
No, for real.
Like, how you run off the off on the LA plug and then go back to LA on a plane?
Mm. Now, I ain't gonna lie, I heard some other shit, but I don't know how factual it is, so I can't even speak on it. But when
we first time, what is
it? It's the only first time. So I'm gonna play a little small clip of Poetic Flocko speaking on the situation. In third person, he said, Brick baby attacked Poetic Flocko at No Jumper after he did this.
Now, check that sounds like one of my titles, because I will be quick to say somebody did something to make you inside of Rookie.
Hey, Rookie, what's up?
In a fool at the Good White Man establishment. And by Good White Man, I mean
Adam 22, the Good White Man.
The Good White Man, Adam 22.
Why you doing that?
Folks, the Neanderthal.
No, I was just going to speed it up.
Well, he struck you before?
Nah, I was gonna speed up just so it's 10 minutes. I was just gonna speed it up.
I can't. It's hard enough.
Okay.
Hearing him not stutter, let alone you speed. You gotta play that shit regular for us older folks. We can't.
Okay.
So I'm like, why the fuck you sound like he drunk?
My bad, older folks.
Neanderthals are acting a
You see everybody like the fuck.
You doing weird shit. Right, my mind. All right, nah, cause you know sometimes when a motherfucker have a long video, you just speed it up so you hurry up and get through it.
No, I just get through it.
Okay. Like, well, look.
You weird. Like, look, who the fuck does that?
Cause you know what I'm saying, shit, 10 minute, mom. Shit, motherfucker be the haul that came back and haul
that. No wonder you can't keep up. You be having too much racing in your mind when you listen to videos. Man,
hey, no, I'm finna do a BRB real quick though.
Okay, let it ride.
All right. Before at the Good White Man establishment, and by Good White Man, I mean Adam 22, of course. The Good White Man, Adam 22, have given these hooligans a huge platform and an opportunity journalists to millions of people, but they've completely gone away from the original
It's on normal
even being on the platform, right? And
then you know he stutter, so he probably taking his time to get
but
his
he
shit
don't
out.
Stutter in his video. Why do okay, hold on. A little side. Why don't like this dude don't never stutter on his video?
Right.
But I just talked to him before, and sometimes he get caught on words real bad. I be like, how many times do he got to record these videos?
Nah, he stutter. He stutter when it comes to shows and shit, like on the podcast. But when it comes to his actual videos, that bitch don't stutter whatsoever. And he don't be stuttering when he lie. But he'll stutter when he on the podcast.
And see, my daddy stutter real bad when he lying or trying to like talk real, like real anxious or something like that. And I know I just said that word wrong. Anyway, let it slide. But that's when he stutter. So that's how I'm like, what the hell? Yeah. I think I agree with Tashana. Just give us like, I don't even want to hear this no more. Because for one, it sounds weird. Now you done got it stuck in my mind, him sounding like a robot. Now his regular voice sounds like a robot.
Shit, you the one spoke on it. Like, I don't.
I know you was about to speed him up, though.
I ain't gonna lie. I didn't even really watch him.
Because you got a BRB. I can just talk about the Quando Runner because I was going to do a video if I changed my mind. Go ahead. So I told y'all back in December that three people were still not revealed on the Quando Rondo federal case. Well, those three people have been revealed and uncovered. And one of the people, right, is Leaky. Now, what stood out to him is that, for one, he just got out in the feds like last year. Now he's back on the federal indictment. But two, if y'all listen to Quando Rondo music, one of his songs, he like, Leaky in the back seat waiting for a body or some shit. So Leaky ass is on that damn indictment with his ass now. So yeah, that's the tea for that. Stop putting your homeboy shit in these fucking songs, whether it's true or not, because they end up on the paperwork right along with your ass. Oh, that was all I had. Damn, my statement wasn't long enough for the be right back. Y'all make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe, tell a friend to pull up on Triple Threat Friday. Music had to go do something, so we just holding it down, okay? Shout out to Shoshana, Loudpad, Born Official TV 504, Miss Me With The BS, Boredom, Kimbella Roxy, who else I saw? Terrence. Who else in here? I'm trying to scroll back through. Jonathan, Zaria, everybody. Okay, it's a lot of comments that I can't scroll back through. Hey, y'all make sure y'all hit that like button. Y'all hit the Cash App. My light's about to get cut off. Y'all help me keep my lights. Like, let me stop before they be like I'm over here lying. But yeah, shout out to y'all. Super Chat, Super Stitch, stickers. I can't even fucking talk. But yeah, y'all. Music, you ain't back here? I guess not. Okay. Well, let me see. I don't know. Y'all know he normally put out everything. I don't know. Trapping, what's up? I don't know what else we talking about. I don't know nothing about the next topic, Kendrick Lamar and Future District. Don't know nothing about that. Yes, the shirt is good. So if y'all was on my live earlier, I thought I burnt up my shirt, but it was just hot. It had to cool off. So yeah, the shirt is good. It's packed up, ready to go. J. Cole, I don't know nothing about what J. Cole got going on. So I guess this is what happens when the main host leave and the co-host sit there and I'm like, I'm over here winging it like,
So, you know what I'm saying? Y'all pretty much got what was going on with your boy, man. Your boy dropped that video and he let it be, hey, goddamn Durk, Bricc baby might go to jail for this shit. Bricc baby responded.
Durk and Bricc baby ain't going to jail. Well, hold on. Durk ain't going to jail for this shit.
Right. Not, and I said it in my video. I just feel like this is a situation where both sides know this entertainment. You know what I'm saying? Both sides know this entertainment. They know what's going on. This, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, Quando Rondo.
That means Bricc baby ain't going to come out and say he was in on it because at the end of the day, that shit going to look goofy to Lil Durk. So the way to say right. Face with Lil Durk is that like you don't even know what's going on.
Right.
But before y'all run with it, listen. The fans already know what area that shit came from, and that's not the area, okay? Just putting right there.
I agree. Now, we're going to get into the shit that been going on today.
Yeah, you got, I was just telling them I don't know nothing about the rest of this shit.
You got your boy, the one
that you say sleep, because you be everywhere, like, Kendrick Lamar, Future, Diss, and Drake, that's like a whole nother sector. Like, y'all has to be everywhere to keep up with all these topics. Shout out to, hey, shout out to Music 101. Because your girl, can't keep up with the drill rapping shit right now, let alone a whole nother. I try to get into the fucking YouTube Carmen, and I can't keep up with that shit because I'm focused on the other shit.
Dude, hey, you got to be, goddamn, you got to be tapped in. So, for the people that don't know what's going on, your boy Kendrick Lamar. Now, before we get into Kendrick Lamar, I'm going to play this right here. But Future and Kendrick Lamar just dropped a song. It's going viral. Your boy Kendrick Lamar dissed J. Cole and Drake. Yeah. So a lot of people is like feeling salty. They thinking that J. Cole is just dissing they thinking Kendrick Lamar is dissing Drake and J. Cole for nothing. But J. Cole and Drake, we might well get into it. Hold on. So for the people that don't know what's going on, y'all know Drake and Future was big dogs. You know, they was dogs. For whatever reason, Drake and Future was smashing the same chick. Allegedly.
That's not surprising.
And the chick
ever flocked together.
Facts. Salute to Step RS for the cash out. And the chick told Future that Drake was pillow talking. Salute to Tracy for the cash out. Appreciate it. So Drake and Future is hitting the same chick. Future allegedly is pillow talking with a chick. And she told the chick something about Future. He told the chick something about Future. And Future respond with this song right here and with Kendrick Lamar. And Kendrick Lamar is taking shots at J. Cole and Drake on this song. And I think he just taking shots because he just joined Future and just like, look, I'm riding with you. But hold on. Should I play the actual song? Should I just break down the actual song? Mickey? Hold on.
My bad. What happened?
I say, should I play the actual song?
Hell no. Hell no. Hey, this first quarter, we trying to get our money. We ain't got no time. I ain't got an email about no copyright shit. And a long time ain't trying to get one. Read the lyrics. Rap it. Matter of fact, rap it for us real quick.
Nah, because I was saying this shit kind of small, so I got to look on my phone. Okay, so. What's this? What is? Oh, okay. So hold on. Let me.
You talking to us?
Nah, because I had looked at something that you had been sent. So it threw me off.
Oh.
All right.
Shout out to Tracy for the cash app. Thank you. I appreciate it. Hey, so, people like Tracy, my ass be like, forget these lives because y'all don't be supporting me for real, for real.
Right, facts.
I know I'm broke.
So, Kendrick Lamar say, oh, my temper is bipolar. I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but cannot be legit, nor 40 water. So is that a shot at 50? He say nor 40 water, you know, 50 cent water. I don't know. But he say no 40.
That's your look. You the breakdown team of that shit, because I don't never be thinking about them lyrics that deep.
he say, tell him. Ah, yeah. Huh, yeah. Get up with me. Sneak dissing. First person shooter. I hope they came with three switches. So he's saying that they sneak dissing him. See, a lot of people is mad because they feel like he just came out of nowhere and dissing them. But Kendrick Lamar feel like he was being sneak dissed. He say, I crash out like fuck rap. This Melly Mel. If I had to, got two T's with me. I'm snatching chains and burning tattoos up. Lost too many soldiers not to play it safe. If he walk around with the stick, it ain't Andre 3K. Because you know Andre 3000 walk around with the flute. So he's saying like it's a stick.
And this got meant away.
So hold on. Think I won't drop the location. I still got PTSD. Motherfuck the big three. Nigga, it's just me. Now, for the people that don't know, J. Cole said, people always asking about who bigger or who better, J. Cole, Drake, or Kendrick Lamar. And J. Cole say, we the big three. So Kendrick Lamar said, fuck the big three. It's me. He say, nigga bum, what? I really like that. And you best work is a light pack. Nigga, Prince outlived Mike Jack. So that's a shot at Drake. Because Drake said he a little bit away from Michael Jackson status. But Kendrick Lamar say, nigga, Prince outlived Michael Jackson, bitch. So you talking about you motherfucking Michael Jackson status, bitch. I'm Prince. He say Prince outlived Michael Jackson.
All I'm going to tell you is before you continue. Up until this moment, I thought Kendrick Lamar was like the most flyest lyricist ever until I heard you read no fucking lyric.
Hey.
And I'm like, is that what's being said? Like, Jesus. Hey.
But see, at the same time, you have to know what the other artists have said, though. for it to
I'm not even talking about what you're saying. It's just listening to you read the lyrics got me looking at Kendrick like, is that what the fuck you be rapping?
Right. Carell said, I like the K-9 joke. The K-9, he said, I like the K-9 Pet Cemetery line. Now, I ain't gonna lie, I ain't get that one. But he said, nigga bum for all you dogs getting buried. That's a K with all the nines. He gonna see Pet Cemetery because K-9. He said, that's a K for all the nines.
And who came back to life?
I don't know.
They ain't Pet Cemetery that come back to life, or did it go over my head? I'm trying to break it down too, but I think it went over
Pet Cemetery. I don't know about this Pet Cemetery. That's why I said I don't know about the Pet Cemetery. He say these niggas
talking coming back alive because that's what Pet Cemetery is for.
A Pet Cemetery, they come back alive.
The movie Pet Cemetery. It's not the movie we talking about.
I have to call Kendrick and ask him.
Okay.
Now, Kendrick also says, verse 2, he say, these niggas talking out the side of their neck. Don't pull no coffin out your mouth. Because, you know, niggas can say some shit, and the nigga, that shit that you said, it get your ass whacked. You know what I'm saying?
You putting hit some people, okay.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Don't pull no coffin out your mouth. I'm way too paranoid for threats. Hey, let's get it, bro. D.O.T. The money, power, respect. The last one is better. Say yes. A lot of goofies with a check. I mean, I hope them sentimental, symbolic, my temperament bipolar. I choose violence. Okay, let's get it up. It's time for him to prove that he's a problem. Niggas clicking up, but cannot be legit. No 40 water. Tell him. So, okay, it's another one. Sneak dissing, first person shooter. I hope they came with 3 switch. Oh, we already read that one. Okay, so we already read that one. So he basically sending shots at J. Cole and Drake. Drake said he a little notch from Michael Jackson status. Your boy Kendrick Lamar say, bitch, Prince lived longer than Mike. J. Cole said, everybody keep asking who the best, Drake, J. Cole, or Kendrick. He say, we the 3 something. Kendrick say, bitch, it's only me. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why Kendrick felt like them boys was dissing him. You know what I'm saying? I don't know why. But he's doing a song with Future. Now, Future on the other end been taking shots at Drake because they allegedly was smashing the same chick. And the chick allegedly told Future some shit that Drake said about him. So Drake put it in a song. Niggas pillow talking. We hitting the same chick. We ain't beefing about no bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all ain't seen Drake and Future drop no album in a minute. You know what I'm saying?
This is definitely outside of my expertise because my eyes is crossing over here breaking down lyrics to these songs. I don't even listen to them.
He say 40 what is E40. Facts. I seen that on Twitter. Facts. Oh. So
we probably should have dropped a link for this
one. Now, I seen it on Twitter, but you know, Twitter be in a bag. Like, Twitter be putting out so much bullshit sometimes. You don't really know what the fuck going on Twitter. But,
hey, ladies, I'm over here like, huh? Look, I was like, what?
Let me see, do they got
the Pet Cemetery line?
Okay, so I'm gonna stop it. You say Kendrick Lamar been wanting smoke since the Control verse. I can go for that. Now this right here, I guess this is Future part sending shots at Drake. I'm gonna stop it. So you know what I'm saying? When I get.
You a nigga number one fan, dog. Sneak this and I don't understand, dog.
You a nigga number one fan, dog. Sneak this and I don't understand, dog. When did Drake sneak this Future though? Did we miss something?
Maybe Drake. I mean, maybe Future ain't talking about Drake.
Wait, but Drake dropped a song where he was saying, dog, like Future flow on this song is the similar flow to one of Drake's songs.
Oh,
I just
don't. Oh my gosh, y'all saw Aggie, not the flow.
Nah, Drake was saying the same thing. Some doubt, and Future gonna do the same shit. So that's why people feel like he was sending shots at Drake. But I don't, you know, I don't really listen to Drake. So, you know what I'm saying? I can't.
You just know it's the same flow.
It's the same flow, and it's the same the way how he dropped the dog shit. And you know what I'm saying? He gonna kick it. So he say niggas sneak dissing and really be fans.
Pillow talking, acting like a fed, dog.
Pillow talking, acting. Now, let me step back. It been accusations that Future and Drake is beefing by the chick. This was said a couple of weeks ago, probably a couple months ago. So that's why the fans is trying to put two and two together. You know what I'm saying?
So the fans is acting like fed.
Come on, man. You know Drake always beefing with a bitch by the female. Every beef Drake had with a bitch, it was by the female. It was by the female. Only person that didn't beef with him by the female was Lil Wayne. Wayne said when he went to jail, Drake started hitting his little bitch on the side. He said he was fucked up in here, but you know, he charged it to the game. You know what I'm saying?
I don't need another fake friend, dog. Can't be about a whole cup of sharing, dog.
Hey, he don't need another fake friend, dog. By the hoe, he ain't beefing about the hoe because we sharing, dog. Say he don't need no other fake friend, bitch. Hey, you know what I'm saying? We ain't finna beef about this bitch because we sharing. Bitch, when I'm in the city, I smash her. When you in the city, you smash her. And we keep going. Yeah, That's just what it is. Ain't no use to tell this bitch this about me and this about me. Like, we ain't doing that.
And your feelings, nigga, why you paying, dog? Give her back shots while she laying down.
And your feelings, why you paying, dog? Give her back shots while she laying down. You paying, but I'm giving back shots while she laying down. Come on, man. Who think this about Drake? Who think this is about Drake? The whole world done already said it's about Drake. The whole YouTube world, the whole internet world already said this is about Drake. Who think this is about Drake?
Keep the clock cock on trust hole. Top shotter going for the gusto. Like a real dog got a mud hole. Get the look.
Come on, man. Like a real dog got a mud hole. Say probably beefing over a girl in their 20s.
Oh, you a giant dog.
Hey, man, I ain't gonna lie, this is actually good for hip-hop though, to be real with you.
This is actually a topic that you take over there on the podcast channel between your fellas. This shit here ain't it, okay?
Hey, This the biggest art. You got the biggest artist in the game right now.
Hip hop beefs is like cat fights with women. Y'all men with this hip hop shit breaking down these lyrics is crazy. I tried it one time, okay, and my people on the truth team told me real quick to never do that shit again. I tried it one time. They said never do that shit again.
I ain't gonna lie. A lot of people feel like Future Verse was shooting at Drake. We don't know for sure. You know what I'm saying? Drake most definitely ain't fucking with Future right now. Before this song came out, it was rumored that Drake and Future were beefing about a chick. But y'all already know, man. If I ain't got,
I mean, why would Future beef about any chick? All them damn baby mamas he got and shit. He ain't lacking on the cootie cat station.
They went. From Future standpoint, he just looking at it why Drake would talk about him to a chick that they both smashing.
Because that's what y'all do.
Don't say y'all. I never agree with that.
Mm-hmm. You look, you know, like a power.
Nah, no. See, one thing about me, and I talked about this before. One thing about me, I would set a bitch up for failure. So I would I would convince a bitch that a nigga is a great man. So when a nigga break a heart, then it's like, come on, baby.
You know, but isn't that still considered pillow talking, even though you're giving out False information.
No, no, no. How? I'm bigging him up.
You said you're dead, is what you saying.
No, I'm bigging him up, baby. You need to go with him. Like, you need, he gonna do you right.
It's still pillow talking, though.
No, pillow talking. We ain't finna do that.
Or two, it is not pillow talking.
Pillow talking is when.
Come on, put in the chat, fellas. Ladies, too.
Pillow talking.
Two, that's not pillow talking.
Pillow talking is when you speaking down on a nigga, telling a nigga business. I'm building a nigga up. Listen. You may think that nigga tripping, but listen, he gonna get it together. Just chill.
No, be with that nigga. Pillow talking is not cop blocking. Pillow talking is when you talking about another nigga to a bitch.
No, not if you building a nigga up though. I'm building a nigga up. Right, but I'm telling the bitch that the nigga is a good man.
You still talking about another nigga to a bitch.
I ain't going with that.
Everybody look, even the lady saying that's pillow talking.
Okay. So just says it's pillow talking, but that's not a bad thing though. That's not a bad thing. If I'm building the nigga up, if I'm telling the chick, look, this nigga is a good man.
He gonna get it together.
Oh. He gonna get it together. See, these lame ass niggas, they'll sit there and talk bad about a nigga. I ain't gonna talk bad about a nigga. I'm gonna say, listen, this nigga gonna get it together. He gonna.
Why you talk about a nigga? Period, though.
No, I'm saying if the bitch is breaking. Let me ask
you this: do you have your shirt off and your boxes when you have this conversation? Like, how are you dressed when you have this conversation?
It depends. Like, shit, we all know. Like, first off, I'm not breaking
up. You laying on your chest while you telling the nigga is a good man?
No, look. I'm not bringing up the nigga. But if she be like, my boyfriend is doing this and my boyfriend ain't treating me right, I'm going to be like this. Look, he going to treat you better. He just going through some shit. He going to treat you better.
Hell nah.
He going to treat you better because what I'm doing is I'm telling the bitch, go be with that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Go be with him. He gonna treat you right. And then when he don't,
even your homie in the chat saying, "Yo, that's the same thing." It get worse as you.
No, wait. Hey, first of all, I ain't got no homie. I ain't got no homie on the internet. First of all, where is Trey?
First of all,
I ain't got no homie.
I don't even know what he think about this.
But look. I'm totally different. See, these lame ass niggas, they'll talk bad about a nigga. I ain't gonna talk bad about a nigga.
It's pillow talking.
But still, Okay, look. I'm pillow talking.
The woman can use to make decisions moving forward. That's still pillow talking, even if it's good shit.
But it's still in a good way, though. I don't give a fuck what you call it. I'm still talking.
You still a pillow talker.
But okay. Yeah, all right, right. But no female can say I talk bad about a nigga.
That's great, but you're still pillow talking.
Okay, well, hey.
So let me ask you this.
She lay on my chest and say,
not sex just because you use a condom?
Some niggas say if you use one, that ain't it. That ain't it, goddammit. If a bitch lay on my chest and say my man broke my heart, I'ma say, listen, he gonna get it together, man. Just trust
me. If a chick is laying on your chest on her man, you need to leave that girl alone because you just
Come on, Mickey.
The first thing she wanna do is talk about another nigga.
You ain't that gangster now, Mickey. So okay, I ain't gonna say you. I ain't gonna put you.
I'm ready. What's up?
Okay. But females does this all the time. Female might fuck with a nigga just because they going through it with another nigga. And then they be like, yeah, you know, he did this to me. And see, I'm the type of nigga gonna be like, listen, baby, he gonna get it right. Just chill. He gonna get it right. Trust me. He gonna get it right. He love you. He gonna treat you right.
Let me tell y'all fellas something. If a chick is that loose lip telling her man business, then you best stop fucking with that girl.
No, because it's a lot of women that done went and slept with another man just because they having issues in their crib.
That's cool, but then they talking about
that
man.
Come on, Mickey, hold on. I know you said you gangster, but not all you women in the chat. Hold on. Mickey, see, that way ain't what you said, that Canadi motherfuckers ain't gonna tell the truth. Now, because, hey, listen, I don't, my whole time of fucking other nigga bitches, goddamn, I done heard an earful. So that's cap. Women do tell a nigga about they nigga when they going through shit. That's cap. That's why they say a shoulder, the crown is a shoulder, is a dick to fuck on. Because women go to other niggas to talk about their problems. So we ain't finna act like just for the internet. See, these lame ass niggas just been here talking for the internet.
Okay, if you want to talk to a nigga about a nigga, you get you one out of the community. I don't see no regular straight nigga talking to, like, come on, the fuck is you a psychologist? Like,
No, therapy, it ain't about being a psychologist, but when women be going through it with a nigga and then they go step out, 9 times out of 10, them women tell what's going on with their situation.
That's what I'm saying. They
loose-lipped. Look, you heard what Tracy say. Facts. I did. I'm trying to tell you. I don't know about these other niggas, but I done hit a lot of niggas' bitches just because they were going through it with a nigga, and they telling the nigga about
that girl shouldn't been giving you her man business.
But they're telling the nigga what's going on.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? Women do that. They tell a nigga.
Oh, I mean, my nigga did it this. Too, but that don't make it right. It's just
either. I ain't saying they make it right. I'm just saying that's what women do. I'm just saying women.
I don't know that.
Look. See, it's just somebody to listen to you, right? Like, come on, yes, don't try to make me like
you
I'm tripping.
There, y'all just mad. Don't try
to make me like I'm y'all tripping. I know for a fact.
Talking about her nigga is crazy.
Listen, like I said, I'm the nigga. They're gonna tell you your nigga gonna do better. Just trust him.
Why you hitting up from the back?
Why I'm hitting? Hey, he gonna treat you right, baby. Just chill. I set you up for failure. Because
well, I'm gonna tell y'all this, ladies. If that's what you have to do, don't cheat. Stay your ass home. Cause obviously, nah.
Not don't cheat, but just don't tell a nigga though.
Don't cheat. Cause if they out, they talking about they nigga. To a nigga, you ain't ready. Stay your ass home. Cause if that nigga leave you, you gonna probably lose your life. So just stay home. Leave that shit for other people.
Say that nigga leave you gonna probably lose your life. So okay. Look, let's get some
leave that nigga alone. Cause ain't no way y'all out here talking to another. Let me tell you something. I'm on some real shit right now. The last thing I want to do is talk about my nigga to another nigga.
Right, and I understand. Listen, I agree with you. But what I'm saying is, it's some women that does it.
Mm-mm. Even now,
I agree with you.
With my husband, if I meet a nigga, I don't want to talk about my nigga. Okay, he's not important.
I agree with you.
To stay in this moment, okay?
I agree with you, but. I'd be lying just for the internet to say some women don't do that. You heard what Tracy said, goddamn. Hey,
I get it, but it's just see me, I'm all about what people character traits they have. And to me, if a man would be telling me all his chick info or what they going through, I'ma look at that as a sign of disloyalty. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna look at that.
I agree.
Situation, so that's why I'm like, for women to be doing that would be a red flag to me as a nigga. If I was a nigga, I would look at that as a red flag.
First off, if you got a nigga and you fucking me, period, that's a red flag. Like, niggas like ain't looking at you like, oh, this gonna be my girlfriend one day. Niggas already looking at you as a red flag.
Because they think they can take the chick from, you know.
Some niggas do, but...
And vice versa, because I ain't going to say just dude, women think that too. But that would just be a red flag, because that means if we get to that level and another motherfucker rub your chest one time, you about to tell all my motherfucking business to that motherfucker. Hell nah.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
And see, look, and this is what the thing, like I said, I know men do it. That's why your ass be arguing with another bitch, and she was like, "Yeah, that's why you couldn't pay that light bill last month because your nigga was fucking telling all y'all kids."
Right, but and see, that's one thing though. Like, I ain't gonna cap. Like, a bitch that got a nigga and she fucking with a nigga, like, bitch, I'm never gonna look at you like, you know what I'm saying? Oh, we might have some, you know what I'm saying? Like, nah. But
you never know now because your toes might curl.
Nah, man, listen, listen. I spoke on it before. I had the best side bitch in the world. She the best bitch that ever stepped foot on earth.
Your hair starting to get thrown at the back of your fucking head and they come up side
bitches. Okay. No, I'm talking about in school.
I can help you, okay?
I'm talking about
school. All I want to do, you but gonna look, make no. me have to be content if your old lady throws in at your
but look, head. Look, this, but look, this real shit though. In school though, and the motherfucker said, "Damn, like why we ain't never been together?" And this bitch like know how to treat a person, like know how to treat a man.
Yeah,
but like you know, young adults even after high school.
I need to play. Go ahead.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Even the look after
high school. I got you. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So and then my thing was like you cold, like you know how to treat a person, but I can't. Trust you though, because if you run around with me, then you know what I'm saying, like right. Shit. So you know you'll be a fool to run around with the man your side chick. If she had a man, like you'll be a motherfucking fool.
But they say ain't somebody that's in a relationship the best to have a situation with? If y'all both got somebody to go home to,
for sure. But to make her your main chick is crazy.
I thought, all the time though.
Yeah, I don't know about that. Like shout out to her. I can't even say her name for real, but shout out to her.
Right,
like she,
y'all was kids, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Right. It was shout out to her though. But you know what I'm saying? I would never look at her like that because it's like, damn, like you have me like thinking like, damn, is you doing the same shit to me? You know what I'm saying? So it'll never work. But get back to the point like we were saying. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, some women point.
But I did see in the comment somebody said young women do that, but grown women, you know, mature women don't do it. But yeah, most, yeah. You know, and yeah. I agree with that too. Grown women do it too, like you know what I'm saying, especially if they hurt.
Grown everybody do it because, like I said, I know a grown ass man, I'm talking about over 35, child. I know all their business in their household. I tell you, all their business.
See, so, you know what I'm saying? And see, that always
all they tell me is to stay the fuck away from that nigga,
right? Because goddamn it, y'all link up, he gonna tell everything, you know okay. what I'm saying? But see.
And see, look, hold on. That's how I feel people out too. I see how loose-lip you are. Right. So before I even try to go somewhere with you on some shit, I got to see how free you are with information.
Facts. I agree. And see,
if you telling me this shit, ain't no telling what you telling your homie. Ain't no telling what you telling your bitch. Ain't no telling what you shit. If I know you free willy-nilly with information to me, you definitely telling your mama everything. And if you was born from your mama, that means your mama got loose lips. So ain't no telling who your mama gonna be telling all this shit with. Come on, man.
Look, say my friend married his side piece. He goes everywhere we go because he's scared out his mind she gonna cheat 7 years later. See what I'm saying? You can't trust the side.
But listen, when you a cheater, it makes you even more when you try to settle down afraid because you like, man, I know how right. I used to be. You know what right. I'm saying? And I'm going to be honest. I went through a little phase in life where, hey, nigga, I know what happens during this time. Like, fuck.
Right.
You know, like, I know the play because, hey, it be guilty conscience, I guess, kicking in.
Facts.
Hey, okay, hold on. On my channel, y'all going to have to take out some of the letters out the cuss words. Don't put words.
Yeah, and I want to address that too. A lot of people that come in and under my videos, they message got erased because y'all putting cuss words. And I spoke on it before. YouTube is now holding the creator accountable for those cuss words that y'all put in the comment sections. So y'all gotta, you know what I'm saying? I understand people feel like they gotta cuss, but just you know, y'all know how to take the shit out, put the X's or the star sign, you know what I'm saying? Because yeah. YouTube feel like that's what you got mods for. When people curse and say crazy stuff in the chat, your mod's supposed to delete the messages. So You know what I'm saying? Let's try to, you know, put stars and abbreviate the
couple. I just had seen that one. I don't know how many was in there. I just, that one just stood out to me. I saw, oh, Lord.
Right, right. So, you know what I'm saying? So, if y'all done coming under my videos and you ain't say nothing crazy and your comment is going, is it most likely you use the cuss word? But yeah, man. Hey, I hope Future and Drake really get it together because they make a great team. They make a great team, and I don't understand how celebrities even beef with each other. You know what I'm saying? Because they all be having sex with the same girl.
Well, they don't be beefing, though.
I ain't gonna say.
You know what they do? This all be publicity. They put the shit in these songs so creators can go dissect that shit. So now we got a whole damn thousands and thousands of videos on YouTube. I see the play. These okay. Is having caviar together on a fucking yacht somewhere while we sitting here breaking down their fucking lyrics to the song. And now everybody who don't even listen, because I don't even listen to Kendrick Lamar. So now I want to listen to the songs. You know, like, this shit right. Is awful.
Right. Now, I ain't going to lie. Some people felt that way, too. Some people said that this is...
What's this trying to... Oh, miss.
Future only beef with Russ. He don't have no real ops. You talking about Russ the rapper?
Russell Wilson. See what? Oh, Russell. Head.
Okay, Russ. Cause she say Russ. I'm thinking it's you know it's a rapper named Russ, the white boy. Man. When she come in that the first time, I ignored it because I'm like Future ain't beef with no motherfucking Russ. You know what I'm saying? but that's true too. But at the same time, and I spoke on this situation too, man. Russell Wilson seemed like a nice guy, though. I don't know. We don't know behind the scenes. Like, Russ could be sending little text messages and antagonizing Future. We don't know. But I said this behind the scene. You and your baby move on. She got a well-put-together man, and he's treating your child like that's his child. Like, what's the issue? You know what I'm saying?
He ain't being a father himself. Like, for real, and I ain't saying he's not doing nothing for his child. My whole thing, and I said this on Mickey True Voice of Truth podcast, okay, make sure y'all stream it, Spotify, all that. But when you're not doing that 1,000%, you're going to always feel a way about another man in the picture. Because when you are 1,000% parent, and I'm going to say parent, because either a mother or father, if you're 1,000% in it all the time, right. Match it, you don't feel like that. It's the ones that know right. They should be doing more that make them feel some type of way when another person is doing more. That's why right. We never had that type of, me and my daughter's father ain't never been together. We was young, you know what I'm saying? I never felt no type of way about that because I knew I do for me. I do for mine. I never had any, you know, issue with... the women he chose to deal with over the years. Never. Now, on his end, he always was jealous of my husband because he knew he wasn't doing what he was supposed to do. So,
fact. Okay. And I ain't gonna lie, I agree with that. I agree with that. And like I said, that's my outlook on it too. If that person that your baby mama or baby father with shows that they really there, like as a good person and genuine, and they treat your child well, I don't see nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? Because that person might can teach your child something that you can't. It might, that person might be, you know what I'm saying? They have best of both worlds. So long as they ain't no creep, long as they on their shit, long as they your child, you know, and then you got to hear from your child or how you feel about this person. Okay, they cool with, you feel like they cool. Okay, cool. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you should have an issue. But like you said,
I ain't gonna lie. I'm about to send that prayer to Mr. Truth. I'm about to say that prayer tonight. You better act right.
What prayer?
Russell Wilson on your ass. That Sierra prayer.
Man, Sierra still ain't tell the bitch what that prayer was. She said, but she that said ain't.
Summer Walker on phone. On
she album. Said it. Right. She said it, but that wasn't that motherfucking prayer.
Look, I need the real deal. I'm about to send that. I'm about to text him right now. I'm like, you better get right. I'm learning that prayer tonight, nigga. You out of here by the morning.
So he got a line for us in every song. But I ain't gonna lie though, too. I kind of understand now, but we gotta look at it too, though, because every time Russ is out with Lil Future, it make the headlines. It look like Russell is just doing it so much of a better father.
They see baby Future with Russell more than Future.
But if they live in the house together, they gonna be the, you know what I'm saying?
No, hold on, no. Hell no, we ain't about to play no games like that. Let me tell you, I know fathers that only see their children every other weekend, but they don't be missing no stuff. They got pictures of them, they do stuff with them. Future right. Just got too many motherfucking kids outside of his damn house that he got spent time with, so he's not as active. And each okay. other's life. He need to get on his booster shit and just get all the motherfucking kids together at one time and just boom.
I can go for that. He do got a lot of kids, and he can't get around to all the motherfuckers like he wished to. And you know, shit, Russ is. I agree with that. And then okay, most definitely I agree, because Russ be at the motherfucking football games. His Future was there at the football games. Bitch, Future be going viral for being at the football game.
Right.
So I agree. I was just thinking that.
I ain't gonna lie. I was just thinking that shit.
What? I feel like behind closed doors, Russell Wilson be knocking the Mario coins out of her head. Huh? What you mean?
That Russell be choking the shit out of your ass behind closed doors. That's what I was saying. I was like, okay. That's gonna be a bitter ass comment to make, though. And then boom, I see Tracy with it.
Okay, now look. Since we speaking on Sierra, now they said every man that Sierra been with, they career have went down the drain.
Hold on, we can't put that shit on no motherfucker.
No, speaker. I'm saying right after she left Bow Wow and all that shit. That's
Bow Wow,
and then Future.
Out, hold on, no, Bow Wow was crashing the fuck out on his own. Okay,
and come so, on. But look, now
don't be drinking enough dirty Sprite sometimes.
Russell just got traded.
I mean, the first time you had like football. I mean, really, like really though. I'm not even a sports person, but look at his stats.
I ain't watched football in so long. I don't even know. But I will say this, though. According to Future, Future said he lost himself when he was with Sierra. He said that
he wanted him to be a good man and not a whore.
He said that he was devoting all his time with her.
Like a good man instead of a whore. Cynthia, how many babies and baby mamas do Future got now? I tell you, Future ass want to be on Dirty Sprite, fucking hoes, and making music that sound the same on every song.
She said Bow Wow still had braids when they broke up. What that got to do?
Okay.
Hold on. Who be beating
and then,
who up?
Shit, Tierra probably got tired of that Dirty Sprite dick every night. Shit. You probably wanted something else. I mean, that shit probably wasn't working all the time. You got to do extra shit because he too fucked up.
Nigga like, falling asleep.
You probably want 10 bitches in the bedroom with him and shit.
I agree.
From the trap house to the White House. Shout out to Sierra.
Nah, I ain't gonna lie. I'm most definitely like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I be saying, like, we don't really know how these people
put Fashawn is coming up there. Because you be sexy sometimes. Put Fashawn the comment up there.
Nah, you know,
a good woman too much for the wrong man. Yes, now Sierra be teaching her children different languages and shit.
She got shit. Hey, say,
Erica Mena. Definitely. Now, you know what? If it's somebody blame for Bow Wow, definitely Erica Mena for sure.
She told Russ, don't beef with him because he live what he rap. They told Russ, don't be with him. Okay, he live what he rap.
I do like Future music, like the older music. Now everything just sound the same.
Man, y'all crazy.
I said he was 5'5", after they broke up, he was 5'3". He lost the inches. Damn.
I ain't gonna lie though, the Bow Wow shit, that shit just seemed awkward to me. The whole Bow Wow shit. Boredom say the link. If y'all want to pull up real quick, man, this ain't gonna be a long live, man. I ain't gonna lie, I'm thinking about going fishing, man.
Okay, go down in the Crocodile Alley.
Nah, I'm definitely ain't going. I definitely ain't going.
And make sure you screen whoever you about to put up on the panel too.
For nah, this boredom. This boredom. Nah, we ain't had no crazy shit in years. For real.
Bruh, you just let a weirdo on the panel last week that I ain't knew what the fuck was going on.
Where?
See, you be doing shit and you
don't even know. Hey, but let's talk about Honeycomb Brazy while Borden pull up. Say she was. Hey, she if you want to be if you want to hit the link, hit the link. Now, Honeycomb Brazy spoke out, and Honeycomb Brazy said, "F everybody, including his family." He said nobody showed up to his court date.
Damn, you right. That was the other day. Nobody fucking knew about it. I don't know if nobody knew about it or not.
Hey, DW, I gotta see who you is, gang. I bet all that when I say I gotta see who you is. Yeah.
Well, no weirdos. Hell no. Nah.
Yeah. Nah. Hey, so
your right name get together.
I tell you, goddamn, you pop up again, be yeah, be banned. But yeah, he said nobody showed up, but this is my thing. What's the end time about fishing? I'm in Florida. Say, but this is my thing. I feel like now I understand where he's coming from, but I feel like he done been in jail most of his life to realize that, bro, you know how the game go. You know when you go to jail, like these people forget about you, like for real. You know what I'm saying?
You know it, but at the same time, you know what I'm saying? Come on. Because he had people, they had this big group when he got out of jail. You know, he was, again, doing all this stuff for people when he got out. So I now understand it, why he felt like that. That shit hit different if nobody in the courtroom, though.
But like I say, I understand it, but it's like, bro, you done been through this shit your whole life, for real.
Well, if he don't trust nobody, who the fuck posted to his social media that he don't fuck with nobody?
It gotta be somebody. Boy, what it do?
Hey,
okay. Boy, got that truth, bar. Salute.
Yeah. Shout out to the truth team. Go to lenaloveleather.com. Get the truth bar. And the pictures don't do it no justice. You did a hell of a job. Thank you, Miss Me.
For sure, for
New
sure.
New York.
Shut up, Mickey. What's up,
for
y'all?
Sure.
You see the truth bar?
Oh, yes. Now we will keep it. And I asked for a scoop. I got a whole jar.
So I ain't even know you was doing that. I just came up here to pop shit, but okay. It was
I got the anal hair stepping.
Okay. Did you say anal?
Ain't no.
I was just gonna say, but I say I ain't gonna say nah.
You gonna let that shout out to boredom? Cause I was like, I be seeing you with your whoops. I might see you with the truth bar, but now we got the truth bar. Okay, look at the whoops. On the
Yeah. Salute, well, y'all. Much love. Keep doing your thing. Shout out to music. Shout out to Mickey Truth.
Salute, hey. Salute. Appreciate Thank you.
Much love, hey. Y'all.
Sure.
To the soul, to the sight.
Miss okay. Me, what it do?
Ain't no need for me to be up here any longer because I ain't even know she was doing that. So she did all that for me. Y'all know what's up.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. Yeah, Miss Me, drop the link to your to your website so they could get the Truth Bar soap and also shop with Nicole, which is Miss Me with that BS, aka Lena Love Lather. You know what
all,
I'm saying?
All my names.
Right. So yeah, drop that link in the what's the name? Y'all make sure y'all go subscribe to Miss Me with the BS too. She on her New York it. She holding it down for New York. She giving y'all that New York content. Also real wild, but you know, she popping her shit in that New York sector. So y'all make sure y'all tap in.
And that's Muwop, baby mama.
You know it. I'm 2 months right now.
Damn, 2 months? That nigga been locked up there 2 years. You 2 months.
Bro, he been locked up like 4 years, nigga.
We've been on some conjugal visits.
Hey, what's that movie?
They got me a trailer. I get to go up there, you know.
Hey, what's the movie with Cat Williams? And he was like, "Now this might be my son, but that damn baby."
You talking about the little Caucasian baby?
Right.
He looked like he about to.
Y'all stupid. All right, I'm gonna put it in the chat.
All right, for sure.
All right, later.
Appreciate you. Hey man, so Mickey, the next topic we got is your boy Boosie and Charleston White. Now, Charleston White supposed to have a show in Baton Rouge, and Charleston White is alleging that Boosie told the promoter, don't book Charleston White or something bad was going
to
happen.
Oh, I thought you were about to talk about the paperwork. Oh.
And now Charleston White said he called the feds, but the feds gave him the county number. But he is making he is making a police report, and he dropped Boosie paperwork, though.
And said
that Boosie snitched on himself. Now I want to say this: Can you be called a snitch if you snitch on yourself?
They call it self snitching.
But is it a situation where you like frowned upon though?
I mean, at this point, I don't fucking know. I mean, we support rats, so I mean, I don't know. But in the Boosie situation. I mean, he said, like, his security, that's his security gun. And, I mean, from what everybody says, that's the plan.
Right. Facts.
That's why I said, like, a lot of these cases, you know what I'm saying, people be like, oh, you don't say nothing but lawyer. But at the end of the day, it's like, real street niggas is not saying just lawyer.
Right. Facts. So this Charleston White right here, man, he feel away. He feel like Boosie done messed up. And Boosie done told this promoter, do not let Charleston White do this show or it's going down. And now the promoter is scared for his life and told Charleston White, don't bring your ass to Baton Rouge.
Now I ain't no Boosie run Baton Rouge.
Because Boosie said so. Check it out.
Boosie, I'm gonna put your motherfucking ass in jail, nigga. Boy, you making threats to the promoter? I got a recorded phone conversation with witnesses on the phone saying the promoter is scared for his life, that he got to live in Baton Rouge, that Boosie go send them people to get you. He said he can't have the show because Boosie goes. I said, nigga, I just hired the police. The promoter scary. Scary ass nigga. Yeah, nigga, Boosie is cool. And I bet he don't want to get in that boxing ring. See, Boosie, you gonna try to send somebody, but you ain't gonna do nothing, bitch ass nigga. I'm gonna put your bitch ass in jail, nigga. I'm waiting for the FBI to send me the right kind of number, nigga, because I'm finna make a report on your you make the man call your name specifically. The promoter specifically said your motherfucking name, little Boosie. He implemented you and implicated you. Bitch ass nigga, you finna go to jail. Back to jail. You gonna be on your knees, but them knees gonna be bleeding again. Diabetic freak.
Ooh.
Why he looked at the camera like that?
It's definitely content. Cause at the end of the day, how you waiting for the feds to call you back with the county number? That man is psyched the fuck out.
Hey. Now, we got one more topic, and we out of here, man. I promise you. Now, this one here is big. This one here, what the world been waiting on. We got Meek Mill and DJ Academics. Now,
I heard Meek Mill tucked his tail.
They say Meek Mill blocked Academics.
I heard he tucked his tail.
But let me tell you though, because you know the chat niggas be chatting. Now I had the chance to talk with one of the chat niggas. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to the chat niggas. They different. You know, DJ Academic little squad over there look different. Now, whatever the case may be, you know, DJ Academic and Meek Mill, they've been going back and forth. But this guy right here is saying that the paperwork is done, it's finalized, that Meek Mill and DJ Academics will have a celebrity boxing match.
that's gonna, they must gonna just be like hosting it. No, they ain't about to fight each other.
Check it out. Let's see what he say.
I just wanted to make it official that everyone knows that the agreement from Celebrity Boxing has been made, and we have signed down here, as you see, for the agreement for $1 million for DJ Academic, $1 million for Meek Mill, and $1 million to the winner. Our investor is willing to put this up to make this match happen. DJ Academic versus Meek Mill. Let's make this happen. The agreement has been sent over to your representatives, and let's make this happen.
Hold on.
Let's make this happen.
He said it was a signed agreement, but then he said, hey, the agreement has been sent over to y'all representatives. Let's make this happen. So is they, did they sign it or they didn't sign it?
Right.
Right.
Now, hey.
That's like, come on, but like, okay, so let's just go with it, okay? Because I think
it's I'm confused.
How the fuck is that gonna, like, that's gonna be the most weirdest, uncomfortable boxing match ever.
Right. I'll curfew. Now, and look.
Let this be a lesson, rappers. Stop going at it with bloggers on the internet. Y'all will not win. Bloggers are made for this shit. Like, time after time, rappers lose. Even if, like, remember everybody came out, Tasha K. You cannot win in an internet beef with a blogger.
Right.
Y'all gotta focus on music and shit. We do this shit all fucking day long. Hell, sometimes a blog against bloggers can't even motherfucking keep up. You got to, like, this shit is exhausting. Y'all leave these bloggers alone.
Most definitely can't.
Now, they get paid to get on here and talk. So you just get like, and he just kept giving AK shit to just come back online. I haven't seen AK on motherfucking stream so much since last year. Okay, this thing. I've been getting rumble alerts all fucking for the past 2 weeks that his ass going live.
Hey, now, look now, since the beef been going on with Meek Mill, I'm finna call Blender Bars and see do he want to pull up and talk about this. But since the beef,
what you got, the, you got numbers and shit like that?
Nah, I'm calling him on Instagram.
No, I'm just saying, let me find out you got connects now to AK. Let me find out you about to be on the record.
Now, for the people that don't know, Blender Bars went viral a couple weeks ago. DJ Academics played his song where he wanted to chat niggas, and he made a song like telling Academics he need to stay on his shit because the chat niggas love him. Now, he called the governor and told the governor on Meek Mill. Check it out. So y'all make sure y'all go subscribe to Blender Bars. I talked to him day before yesterday. I'm finna call him while this video is playing and see what he pull up and explain what made him call the governor on Meek Mill. Y'all check it out. But y'all make sure y'all go subscribe. Say shout out to the chat niggas. Yeah, y'all know Academic Squad look different. Them boys don't even play over there.
When they held court against old buddy, was crazy that night. That shit was crazy. I forgot that happened this year. That shit was crazy.
Yeah, they did their own little thing, man. But this is Blender Bars. One of the Academics fans, chat nigga. He called the governor on Meek Mill to tell the governor what Meek Mill is doing to DJ Academics.
Office. To be connected to the governor's office, please press 3.
Press star to repeat.
You have reached the office of the governor. Your call will be answered by the next available representative.
Please be aware that all calls are recorded for quality assurance, monitoring, and record-keeping purposes. By continuing this call, you are consenting to the recording, retention, and use of this call. Your position in queue is
1.
What the fuck is this?
Hold on. You know they got him on hold. He trying to wait.
Oh, okay.
We appreciate your patience. You may contact our office at any time via the online form at governor.pa.gov/contact.
Your position in queue is
1.
I would have hung up by now. I ain't gonna lie.
Hello, good afternoon. I'm calling as a concerned citizen of Philadelphia, and I'm calling about Meek Mill, the rapper named Robert Meek Williams, who's making threats online, and he has public appearances with our governor. He's making threats of contract killing, cocaine distribution, and weapons trafficking online. And this is an image that he's portraying to the youth.
What were those 3 points again? Sorry.
You said contract killing? Yes, he's paying people to kill other people. He's distributing cocaine and he's trafficking weapons. And he's admitted all of this.
Okay, 1 second.
Hey, I ain't finna commentary on the video yet, cause I'm trying to get my boy up here. I know he was watching the live earlier, but I don't know where he at, where he from. But I'm trying to get my boy up here before I really do it. Let's chill. I'm trying to get my boy up here, man. I'm finna call him again, though. Y'all take it light, man. Listen, y'all got to realize, too, though, he's a chat nigga. He's with DJ Academics by any means necessary. God damn it. Anybody go against Academics is up. Y'all got to understand. Academics got a cult following.
Crazy.
He got a cult. He say McMill has, god damn it, done sell drugs, done paid for hits and some other shit.
That shit.
My boy, hey, y'all gotta understand, this is Academics, people. They don't play by act. So whatever they gotta do to get McMill off the street, that's how they coming.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? But hey, I ain't gonna do too much talking on it. I'm trying to get my boy up here, though. If hey, Blender, if you watching, pull up, gang.
I'm going to be calling to the Florida damn governor of the mini, man. Stop.
Damn, where you at, Blender? And we're going to play your song. Pull up, bro. We're going to play your song, too, goddamn it. We're going to give you a lot of promo, gang. Pull up, man. I know he was watching earlier, so.
Is Blender a real person or AI?
Nah, he real deal.
All right, like, let's get the shirt down here. I'm having some conscience for sure.
Like he fucked me up at first. Like, when I talked to him, I'm like, and then when I seen the video, I'm like, bro, you sound like the nigga that made the call. He was like, yeah, that's me. So that's when I looked at his YouTube.
Oh, that's his real voice.
That's his real voice.
Oh, okay.
And then you're going to hear when his son say he a rapper. Yeah, he a rapper. He made a song called Chat Niggas to Academics. He the person that Academics played on the stream. He played the song. He made a song to Academics. We're going to play that next.
Yeah, so
appreciate you calling in here. Anything else you'd like to add to the comment here?
Yes, yeah, so that all of this is documented and everything is open statements and public statements from him. And his real name is Robert Meek Williams. And he also threatened to kill a hip hop blogger named DJ Academics. He said that he's going to come hunt him if he keeps playing with him.
Said a hip hop blogger, you said?
Yes, his name is DJ Academics. The Academics is spelled with a K. There's no C after the A.
Why he ain't say Livingston?
And then the C at the end as well, before the S, it has a K.
Okay. All right. Okay, I got that down here. All right, appreciate you sharing that. Anything else to add to the comment here?
I just want to
add that I hope that the violence stops and that we stop encouraging violence and that the governor really considers who he stands next to in public. That's it.
This could backfire.
All right, thanks. Would you mind providing the zip code you're calling from? If you don't feel comfortable with that, that's okay too. As a zip code?
Yeah, 19125.
All right, I appreciate it. Just helps the governor know where folks are calling in from. Okay, thanks for that. I will get this forward along for the governor's review. You know, that did happen back in December, but certainly, you know, what's happening today. I really appreciate folks calling in and sharing this and letting us know about it. What happened? It's like the, you know, the picture and everything with the probation.
Okay. Like, I know there's probably content, but that sounds like a real call, right?
That's a real call.
Okay, so, and I get it. However, it would be one thing if academics never responded to me. Academics have went back at me multiple times. So it's kind of like even playing field to a certain extent. So I'm just like, why would he call and say that type of shit? Like, for real.
You know, them chat niggas, man. And then, but if you heard what he said was, I appreciate everybody calling. So he wasn't even the only one.
Right, but my thing is this, and I get on the internet, we have our like favorites and shit, but if your favorite is indulging in this shit, like calling somewhere and saying people are threatening to kill people, it's criminal. That's not just no, hey, you
best stop selling drugs.
Somebody. Like, that's some other shit. Ugh.
And selling drugs.
Yeah, that's a little different. I feel like, you know what? Shout out to Blender Bars. But AK need to talk to his chat and that, like, that's too far. Yeah. Now, calling to say, hey, he's supporting people that's whatever, but the shit he reported to the people is crazy.
Nah. No jumper even. He said, I tried to reach out to him. Yeah, he got his Instagram page is on silent mode, so he probably don't even hear. What?
I don't even want to call somebody that done called the governor's office and said that people is trying to kill people and selling dope.
Nah, we gotta get him up. We gotta get him up here. Like, we got.
No, you do what you want.
No, I just want him to explain to the people his motivation behind it. Like, you know what I'm saying?
That's a lot.
Trapper say, AK told them to do it on stream. He paying all of them.
See?
Say, academics paying motherfuckers to call.
That's crazy.
I'm finna play the rest of it real quick, and then I'm gonna play the song, his song, just a piece of his song, just to show y'all, like, this just not.
No, I don't even want to hear no more of that call. Nah. Like, that shit crazy.
And you don't want to hear no more of the call?
Yeah, words like that's not entertaining to me. That shit there is just different.
Hold on. Let me play the chat, niggas, man.
Yeah, see, that just goes a little, now that's too far. Staging a fight or something, okay, but that there is too far.
Okay, hold on. Let me find it. Here it go right here. So, I'm finna play a little piece of the song just to show y'all how much of a, you know, a chat nigga he is to DJ Academic. And DJ Academic
is playing this song. I'm looking at music like he was.
Hi, this is content. I'm showing you the content. God damn, you always try to throw me into the blender.
You love
this is going viral. Like, No Jumper
played. I ain't heard nobody talking about this shit.
Ooh, he made it to No Jumper. They played it today.
Like, a couple weeks ago?
No, today. They played it today. Yep, no, yesterday.
on no jumper. Well, shit. I mean, it makes sense. You got Poetic Flacco putting Ricos on niggas over there. So I guess so.
They told him on no jumper, he needed to get a job.
And you brought in a triple threat. Okay.
Hey, this was going viral. Triple threat is was we talk about the viral topic. This was going
viral. I ain't heard no viral
I already took one topic out of it for you. God damn, I gotta take this one out for you too.
No, go ahead. You like the police shit. This your set. Hey. Go ahead.
But I just want to play the song and show you how much of a fan he is to DJ Academic. Then y'all might get it.
You're
y'all
intrigued by Mr. Bars. Go ahead.
Y'all make sure y'all subscribe to the one and only Blender Bars.
Yeah, it's Blender. You ask the chat to hold you accountable, Ack. The time has arrived. This a message from the chat. This is not a diss track. This a letter to Livingston, also known as Big Ack. Through the fire and the drama, the chat always had your back. And you said that you would catch up on the streaming, that was cap. This a message from the chat. This is not a diss track. This a letter to Livingston, also known as Big Ack. Through the fire and the drama, the chat always had your back. And you said that you would catch up on the streaming, that was cap. Treat the chat just like a thotty, how you sell us all a dream. I'm still rocking with you, Big Ack, but I'ma keep it a bean. Plus, you cannot mute this message like you do in all your streams. Come back real apologetic, then you go set your routine.
That I've seen him do it.
I've been watching all your videos since I was just a teen. You keep playing our computers, then you might lose all your steam. And I know you saw the super chats that came across your screen. And you need some real professionals that's working on your team. Academics got more bangers sitting in the lost and found. All these bozos copy you, but only one can wear the crown. And you front like you gon' stream, and then you play us with the count. And the time it took you to show up, I could be out of town. This a message.
Hey, so y'all kind of get it. My boy made a song to Academics for
I hope he hit your fucking computer. You was too excited on this shit here. This shit here, nigga. Like, this shit here, nigga. Okay? Give me, y'all remember Stan? The Eminem song?
Hey, my boy made a song to Academics for not streaming often.
And then call the governor. This too much. This and you was over cheesing like a kid in a fucking candy store the whole fucking time. I don't even see this shit on no jumper.
No, you tripping. He showed the clip on his. It's on his Instagram. He played the clip.
Oh, no jumper on Adam.
Oh, hold on. Because they say he need to get a job with Flacco. Hold on, I'm player. With Flacco, when on Flacco segment.
Oh, on the video.
Yes, on the video.
Hold on. Okay, that's fine.
That's what you do with your day? You call the governor's office about leaking your tweets and lyrics?
No.
Even Flacco says too much.
Yeah. This is Blender Boys, by the way. Yeah.
Word of the day. J-O-B. Yeah. Job. Go get one. For sure. Yeah.
They say even Flacco says too much. You know Flacco Federale. Salute. Hey, he went viral. You know what I'm saying? So it was only right, man, that I had to put that boy in there, man. What y'all think, chat?
You the fucking police.
Yeah, good dude, man.
You definitely the police.
Hey, I'm gonna do like Academic do. I'm gonna play that motherfucker. He said, "What you gonna do when the fan make a song?" Hey, I'm gonna play that motherfucker. God damn it!
I ain't playing shit. Don't make no song about me or to me, cause I ain't playing shit.
Say, y'all think he obsessed with Academic, but he like you heard what he said.
Give me Stan. Do y'all remember the song Stan?
Right, but he say, but you gotta understand. He said he been watching Academic since he was a kid.
Yeah. Yeah. Was that a point that was supposed to deter him from the Stan moment?
Damn, I wish my boy answered, man. Oh, he responded. Hold on.
Don't shake too quick now.
Hold on.
The excitement in your face is like.
Hey, bro.
Hey, bro. I saw you were calling. What's up?
I just played your video on Instagram. I mean, on live tonight, and I just played your song. I wanted you to pull up and shit, and just, you know, pop your shit real quick. We got a couple questions.
Oh, okay. Are y'all still on?
Yeah, we still on. I'm finishing you the link.
Okay, yeah, send me the link. You're on. Yeah, I see you right now. Yeah, you're on my sub.
Okay. Okay, I'm finna drop the link in the chat.
I'm doing it on my personal channel. It's some Warm Triggers, because that's the one on my TV. But it's me.
Okay, I'm finna drop the link. Just pull up. I'm dropping the link in the comment section right now.
All right. I don't have no questions. You can have this one all to yourself.
So, you know what I'm saying? Bro, I'm finna pull up real quick. And, Cat, what it do?
Oh shit! Don't go off camera now. This is y'all. Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. tell a friend to pull up on this hot ass fucking panel.
On fucking triple threat, man. We got the one and only Blender Bars pulling up, man. He the one who called the governor on Meek Mill, man. They actually said, you know, they thankful for the information. He the one who dropped the song, you know. Salute to him. He dropped that song for academics. Salute to him, gang.
I don't know what the fuck to say.
You know what I'm saying? Like I said, they just reacted to his video on No Jumper. He been going viral. Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button, man.
Definition of viral is like not the same.
I'm saying if you make it to No Jumper, you viral at that point, right? Like, let's just be real. Like, that's a big platform. Like, let's just be real. Now, am I
tweaking? Thirsty. That's exactly what it is. Music just love domestic content for sure.
How? This is going like this is a part of the Meek Mill DJ Academic beef. Like this, like
what is it?
We gonna leave this out.
I mean, it definitely should have been left out for sure.
He told me he's just left out.
Okay. I'm down for like this shit just ain't real policey. Like for this shit thing, like
hold on, Mickey. Bro, you got to click that link right there. That's in the chat. You hear me?
On the YouTube chat?
Yeah, on the YouTube chat. You see I just dropped the link? You got to click on it. And they're going to pull you backstage and I'm going to let you up. You see it?
Yeah, the stream yard.
Right.
Yeah, I'm connecting now.
Okay. I'm finna pull you up once you get back there.
Who would have deleted something?
No, she was saying deleted.
Under bars.
Yeah. I'm just waiting for you to pop up. Okay, there you go. Brody.
Oh my God.
Bro, you hear me? Say something, I can't hear you.
He can't talk with that man on his face.
I can't hear you, bro. Now you just went black. Okay, hold on. He's coming up under another one. Okay.
Hey, can you hear me?
Okay, I can hear you now, bro.
Yeah, it's because I joined and then it was like a third party browser. And then okay. I had to, yeah.
Alright. Hey man, you know, I just played the video with, you know what I'm saying, you calling you know, the governor, and I played your song to academics. I just want to know, like, what gave you that motivation to call them? Like, and you know what I'm saying? Let the people know, because the people are looking at it like, damn, like, you know what I'm saying? It's crazy that bro did that. Like, so I wanted them to get firsthand, why did you call on me? And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, absolutely. No, I appreciate you having me here. So reason that I really called Meek is that there's something that I really wasn't going to do. I was sitting on a sideline, but Meek Mill threatened Ack, and he said, I'm going to come hunt you. And then he went on the radio and did a freestyle saying that he's purchasing 3 Dracos after he came back from vacation from Turks and Caicos. So that's weapons trafficking. And he's openly threatening academics. And then he also said, this is where the perspective changes. He's supposed to be a street dude, but he went online and said, academics got many of my friends killed. So that's when I said, okay, we're going to turn up the heat. We're going to put the pressure. He wants to use, he wants to use these criminal words online, and we're going to put his out there. It's not crimes. It's not snitching. It's his own words.
Okay. 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 So tell the people your connection to academics. Like, I played the song, right? I played the song. Tell the people, like, you a chat nigga, right?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You're a chat nigga. So, like, just tell the people, like, you know what I'm saying, the history with the way you feel about academics. Like, you've been watching them for a minute, like, and then tell them about the song. What made you create that song? Right. So they could get a gif of why would you go on that limb for academics? Because a lot of people don't understand why is you writing so hard for academics.
Right. So I've been listening to academics for about 10 years. I was still in high school when I was listening to academics. And then I always heard his unique perspective. And then I always saw the haters, and they kept talking and talking, but he always kept hitting them with content, with content. And it was always with a unique angle with his personality in it. And then I've always been by his side. And then I've seen that he stopped streaming. And I know he's been going through some personal issues and all that. And I know it's affected his work ethic. And I see all the people in the comments. Like, I'm deep in the comments. Like, I'm in the digital trenches. Like, I'm literally in there. Like, I'm in Mickey's comments. I'm in your comments. I'm in Vlad's comments. I'm in Axe comments. I'm in Sage's. I'm in there. No, but yeah, so I see all the chat people, like, and it hurts. I'm like, they say I'm disappointed. They say I'm done with him. They say this is my last time coming here. They say all these crazy things. I'm like, it's like he's throwing away a cherished community.
Right.
So I was like, I'm going to step up to the plate. And I was like, yo, I'm going to drop this. And then it was kind of like not, it was in a semi-troll way, because I'm not going to go hard and like do a diss, like a hard record, like a street record. But it's like a satire in a way, but with a message. And then I'm always in the chat. And then I was like, I'm going to do a super chat. And then I sent a super chat in a live. And then from there, people started getting the traction. They started following along. They started sending their own. Okay. And then he was like, who's sending this? What does this mean? A letter to Livingston. And then he pulled it up live on stream. And then from there, he played it. And then he shouted me out. And then from there, I've just been pumping out content.
Okay, how you felt about No Jumper playing your clip today and responding? And how you felt about that? Like, were you as excited? You looked at it as a diss? You looked at it as an acknowledgement? Like, how did you take that in?
Nah, so I actually be talking to Flaco on the low. Like, this an exclusive on your channel. Not going to say any subject matter on that, just out of respect. But that's one of the creators that I respect. I like his angles too. I like how his, I like his work ethic. This man every single day pumping out content, content. He doesn't care what people say. They say all of these crazy things about him, but he doesn't care. So I said, I like his angle, and he doesn't care when people call him a snitch. So I said, he does a similar thing where he goes hard on exposing rappers with their own content. So I said, yo, I put this together. Because I put a couple pieces together already. Mm-hmm. And then he was like, yo, like, this one's cold. And then I was like, all right, bet. I'm going to do some more and then see if we can promo something.
But was the call real?
Yeah, absolutely.
You don't think that was a little too far?
Like, what do you mean too far? What I said?
Yeah, like calling the actual governor's office saying that.
No, DJ Academics asked me to. He's asked the entire chat to do it. And only the realest of the realest going to step up. You didn't see that part, Mickey?
Flacco would do that, though. Like, Flacco definitely pieced it together, like, in a video. But I haven't heard him make, like,
actual real. You didn't see the trailer I made of Meek Mill? It's 1 minute. If Musies would pull it up. I mean, it's not like I'm trying to milk promo. It's one.
It's on.
Minute.
Nah, you good? It's on your page.
Yeah, it's on my page.
Oh no, Music is loving this. Trust me. Okay, this
yeah, it's 1 minute. You're gonna see how Meek Mill is implicated in all this. Okay. We're putting pressure on Meek Mill. Robert Remeek. Remeek's Reckoning coming soon. Okay. Watch the trailer.
It's called Meek Mill documentary trailer.
Yes.
Hey, y'all, make sure y'all go subscribe to. Blender bars, man. That motherfucker some crazy, man.
Cinematic quality. All right, watch from the chat.
Y'all, listen, man. Y'all ain't scared that Meek Mill. Like y'all put. Listen, man. Y'all put too much pressure on Meek Mill, man.
Man, he's gonna come with the three Dracos. That's a lot of firepower. That's the 7.62x3.9s.
All right, hello. I'm gonna play the clip.
All right, let's see what's going on.
Hey, man.
What'd you think?
Hey, man. Hey. Damn, so you making a documentary?
Yeah, I mean, it's not going to be like cinematic, but it's going to be like, yeah, I'm piecing it together like a Trap Lord Ross. He's another one of my inspirations. Because we got to expose Meek Mill, because everything, all the tyranny that he's been putting out on these streets is hypocritical. If he never stood up and said, I want to help the people that have fought through the justice system, that have suffered and they want to better their lives, and then he goes in the booth and says, I'm distributing cocaine, I'm bringing arms into my community, I'm paying other people to kill other people, that's harmful.
But you don't think it's just rap, though? Like, it's just like, you know, these rappers just be rapping.
How many followers does he have on X, for example? You don't think his voice has impact?
Yeah.
Like, he has 11 million followers, and in his bio in X, it says Killadelphia. So, like, off the jump when you visit his page, it's like he's promoting murder.
I don't agree with this at all. This is too much.
Not gonna Mickey don't want the heat, but I know in her inner civilian she agrees. But I respect Mickey.
They call my city Columbia, so I mean that's the culture of it. I just don't agree with. For one, I'm against actual police using lyrics against people. So I for sure ain't trying to like be with the internet using lyrics to call governor's offices and stuff or create a campaign like that. That's beyond just content at that point. Because if it was really, to me, if it was really more about what he's promoting is other ways to do that other than to just do a smear campaign.
No, I respect that, but remember, this is a step between criminal charges because the governor's office is just so I can make the governor aware to stop doing business with him because he's going to promote anti-violence campaign and put blood money for a propaganda campaign to get PR.
Why didn't you call it to the police then?
Why would I call the police?
Like, why wouldn't you just like call the police instead of the governor's office?
Because academics asked specifically for the governor's office, and I'm not a police investigator as a professional.
I mean, I just personally don't agree with it, but hey, do your thing for sure. Because the slasher trailer was something. So you definitely are good with the edits and stuff, but I just, the motive behind it ain't personally my cup of tea. But hey, keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah, no, I appreciate the feedback. I definitely appreciate that. We don't agree on the subject of it, but I definitely appreciate the words, Mickey.
Oh, no problem.
Have academics, you know what I'm saying? I got one more question. I'm going to let you get out of here. Have academics, you know what I'm saying, like seeing your work, like seeing the calls, seeing the trailer?
So he hasn't seen the trailer or the call because he hasn't gone live until tonight since I dropped it. And then he's talking about the Drake and Kendrick Lamar stuff right now. But he says he's going to get to Meek Mill later tonight. So that's my hope. That's truly, like, we're going to push it hard tonight. Because Flocka already reacted, we did a We Love Hip Hop in Canada. I don't know if you heard of them. They got like 25,000 subs on YouTube. They reacted to it too.
Right. I was telling them that, you know what I'm saying, a lot of people, you was going viral. A lot of people were reacting to it. But hey, man, salute to you, man. I'm most definitely going to tap into Academics Live tonight to see how.
What time he go live?
Yeah, what time
he's live now? He's live. Mm-hmm.
Okay, yo, we finna get ready and shut this down. Y'all let Act know, man.
Shout out to Blender Bars. Y'all make sure y'all follow him on Instagram and YouTube.
Yep, the Instagram is Blender Punches.
Okay. And then, you know, y'all make sure y'all subscribe to his YouTube channel, Blender Bars. He most definitely got some heat over there, man.
All right. Salute, appreciate y'all for having me.
Appreciate you. For sure.
Definitely.
All right. You want to chop it up. Take care.
All right. Hey.
Boy, that was interesting.
Hey, man, academics.
You have crossed over to Illuminati.
Hey, academics though, man. You know what I'm saying? That's a whole different breed over there, man. He say academics do it.
That's what's up.
Like, not
true team. Why y'all don't do what I tell y'all to goddamn do?
I'm trying to tell you, goddamn. It's not. Is we gonna put the 100% blame on him, or are we gonna 50-50 with him and academics?
I'm not gonna go there. I'm gonna leave that one alone. Okay. I just had the voice just in real time that I didn't agree with it, but hey. That's your content, but yeah, so, I'm down alone.
This was a disaster. Listen, we had to react to it. Everybody been reacting to it. No Jumper already reacted to it. Like, this ain't, like, you know what I'm saying? I know that y'all, it probably missed y'all radar, but, you know, I be watching, like, No Jumper. Once I seen No Jumper react to it, I'm like, okay, it's a go. Y'all know how I rock. When it comes to...
But have you reacted to it, though? You just been...
I haven't. No, I wasn't going to make a video.
On it? Music?
No, I didn't react to it like make a video.
No. You haven't gave your actual reaction. You just been building up the content. What's your reaction to all of what you presented us tonight?
Oh, I don't have nothing to say about Blender Bars. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't, I'm not going to even, you know what I'm saying?
You kind of sound like Flocka right now. Like, so how do you feel about him covering, calling the governor's office on Meek Mill?
Hey, I told, but like, I'm going to say what I told him. Like, I told him in the comment, in his DM.
No. So you deflect then.
No, I'm going to tell you.
Audience, you got my reaction. The our viewers have reacted. We want to know, how do you feel about Blender Bars? Shout out to Blender Bars calling the actual governor's office on Meek Mill, even though Jumper gave their reaction.
Like I told him, and when I seen it, I DM'd him and told him, I said, "You chat niggas crazy."
No, see, you always be trying to play safe.
That was my
creating content, but you trying.
That
to
was my shit. Opinion. He
okay.
Chat,
so
the chat niggas crazy.
So what does that mean?
The chat niggas crazy mean like I wouldn't have did it. Like, you know what I'm
saying?
Like,
why wouldn't you have done it? You love content. Everything is content.
I'm most definitely not.
You have not done it.
Because I'm not finna call the police on nobody. You know what I'm saying?
Well, he's not the governor's office. Like you said, he's not an official police officer to like do that.
The governor, like that's what I'm saying. Okay, put it like this. I don't agree with it, first off. You know what I'm saying? I rock with academics, but I fuck with me. But I don't think it's that serious.
Oh no, you might as well take Meek up off your list at this point.
Nah, I fuck with me, but I just feel like I don't think it's that serious what him and academics going through to really involve like public officials. You know what I'm saying?
Academics actually felt, no, I'm pretty sure he knew somebody out of the whole flock was going to call. Because I was about to say, I wonder if he really thought somebody was going to call.
But that's what I'm saying. Like multiple people called. He just recorded his phone call. Cause you heard what the governor said. He was like, "Thank you, thank y'all. I thank y'all for calling and letting us know about this situation."
So let me ask y'all this though: do you think that shows that academics is using his platform for the wrong thing? Because if his voice is that powerful to have people actually making complaints to the governor office.
I say this, and this ain't got to
do ain't that's the equal, because Blender Bar said, you go to Meek Mill page, and it say, kill Delphia and all that. And his voice reaches so many people in his raps, but AK literally sat on stream and told people to call the governor's office, and they did. So isn't that the equivalent to mean the same thing? They're both using that voice for the wrong thing?
I agree. And like I say, I feel like academics, because I feel like they don't really have beef for them to be trying to destroy each other's character.
I haven't heard Meek Mill tell his fans to go do something academics though.
I haven't either, but I'm just going by what Blender is saying. Like,
but You was pushing this content a little bit, and I just want to know.
How I'm pushing the content? Listen. My platform ain't shit compared to No Jumper. Like that's what y'all like. Not you, Mickey, but the fans gotta realize. Once a major platform react to it, like us little guys ain't shit. So I don't give a damn if I reacted to it a whole week. It still don't amount to the time or that 30-second clip that No Jumper reacted to it, because they're a worldwide fan base. Like it's totally different. Like y'all be taking this internet shit too crazy. Like me reacting to it is not shit compared to No Jumper.
I mean, I get where you're going with it, but that's not really the notion here tonight. Now again, I do like the fact that you allowed him to come, like give his side of why he's doing it. But I just felt like that was crazy.
Like I'm saying, I don't like I said, when I first heard the video, I DM'd him. I said, "Bro, you niggas crazy." Like, I don't agree with it. You know what I'm saying? But the reason why I played the song to let y'all know, like to let y'all see the aspect, you got to understand that he is a fan. He's not a fan. He's a chat nigga. He's a part of the team. Like you got to look at it how he looking at it. I'm not saying how they looking at it and what academics doing is right. But what I'm saying is he is a part of academics team. Right. That's just he like just like Brick Baby say the Kill Squad. You feel me? And now it's going viral, the Kill Squad. If academics say shoot, they shooting. You feel what I'm saying?
Right. So I'm just saying, like, when that type of content, you don't like bring it all around, because he sat on here and said like he did this because of what Meek is pushing, but in the same sense, academics is doing the same thing that he's saying they're against.
Right. But that goes back to what I was saying. They don't even, you know what I'm saying? They like, listen, I'm not finna defend academics.
Okay, definitely Rico's coming, okay? The internet Rico's coming, okay?
Say chat nigga sound like a gang.
Academics gonna be at the top of the fucking indictment, and me Bill gonna be on the other one.
Like, I'm not, you know what I'm saying? That just like yesterday. Was it yesterday? I think it was yesterday or day before yesterday. Whenever he put it out, I seen the video. But I didn't respond to it. Y'all, if y'all motherfuckers that know me know, I'm not gonna speak on something that's incriminating until a big platform speak on it. When a big platform speak on it, then that's a go. Because now, goddamn it, 9 times out of 10, our whole little side of the world done seen it. Like, you know what I'm saying? So you know what I'm saying? That's when I speak on it. But I can't defend, I'm not finna, you know what I'm saying, try to defend the chat niggas, like in academics. I'm not finna do that. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is, I don't agree with it. I don't agree with it, but I'm looking at it's a difference. That just like with whoever else, any other famous person that got a cult following, when they say do, the motherfuckers do. You know what I'm saying? We just ain't got there yet.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? One day we gonna get there. And when we say go, they gonna go.
You my voice for no shit like that though.
Nah, for sure.
But not only thing, you know, I feel like, and I just want to use this as an example. I just feel like us as creators, we have to, when we have this type of content, we have to bring that shit with a message towards the end, and like we have to close the door.
But see, that's the thing. Ain't need no message on that one. You know what I'm saying? That just beef. Like they just
no.
Beef.
The message was because you brought him up, and he elaborated on everything, and it just was out in the open. Like, you feel me?
I feel like
you never say you didn't condone it, like during the content.
No. I don't condone it. Like I don't. Like I kept saying, I don't agree with it. Cause I feel like this.
I ask you though. This is why I was saying you don't like close, like okay, boom, there we go, wrap it up type thing. Like you didn't say you didn't condone that type of stuff at all until I asked you.
Because I'm saying like, do I got like okay?
Because you said you got to be held accountable. Remember you said that at the end of last year.
Right, but some things. You like sometimes you should be able to read people's body language without them saying anything to know do they condone certain things.
All you see you do is smile the whole time during the
if I'm laughing, this shit is completely entertaining. Like I'm you know what I'm saying? Like you know,
if y'all just join us. Hey, the replay gonna be crazy. Okay, shout out to everybody that pulled up. Shout out to our special guest that pulled up, Blenda Mars. Okay, a real certified chat nigga from AK. You know, hey, y'all make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe, tell a friend, pull up on this federal ass triple threat Friday. Okay. And yeah, that was definitely some content for sure.
Nah, I just want to say this though. I don't agree with it, and I feel like academics and Meek Mill beef is not even close to being serious for situations like that to be taking place.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? Like they just got a disagreement. Like, you know what I'm saying? Nobody have been killed, no have been shot, nobody have been beat up. Like, I don't think
he ain't say that. What?
Right. Like, I don't feel like, you know what I'm saying?
Put a hit on your head if they move like that, okay.
Right. I just feel like it was too much for real, for real. Like they not in a situation where it's like real beef for, you know, government officials to be called. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, this is messing with Meek Mill character. This will mess with Meek Mill situation with the governor. You know what I'm saying? If you got chat niggas calling talking about he done put hits on people and he promote violence and
thing. Like Rick Havoc said, it's all for the internet, right? When you make actually, at first I thought maybe it was like an AI call for entertainment, but when you're actually calling government officials and all that, that takes it to another level. And that's why I had to like clarify with him, like, was that really the governor's office? He was like, yeah, and then he actually had a logical explanation in his way. Hey, Meat Mill is promoting this, doing this to the community, doing it, like he was for real, and he's like, it's more to come. That they're making it real light. It's no longer the internet. And I feel like the internet that got so bad, social media got so bad, where it's not a line anymore between internet and real life. That shit intertwining with each other, and it's crazy.
Right. And I ain't gonna lie, I agree, because at the end of the day, this shit is all just internet disagreement, right? Mm-hmm. But then the reason why I played the song and see it's going over a lot of y'all head, because a lot of these people that look up to these celebrities really feel a part of whatever that person or celebrity got going on. This is serious to them. Like when he was up here talking, he wasn't laughing. He was dead motherfucking serious.
Oh, we know.
You know what I'm saying?
We know.
So that's why I tried to show y'all like, you know what I'm saying? Because to them, this is serious. They feel like they got to call these people on Meek Mill because he's doing this. To us, we looking at this shit like, man, they tripping because this ain't serious. But to them, this is serious because they so invested into who they look up to. That's why I'm trying to tell. So that's why I played the song to let you hear. He been watching him since he was a child.
Right.
He look up to him. He made a song about academics.
Oh, he's playing it now?
He's playing blender shit.
Uh-huh.
He is playing that shit. Let's see. So that's why I was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is serious to them. Like, to us, we looking at it like, man, this shit is out of hand. But
shout out to Blue Bars. Is it raining? It sure is.
And I want to say something too. You know what I'm saying? This ain't no disrespect.
Here come the disrespect.
If y'all ain't up under them big bloggers, motherfucking comment sections, telling them what not to do and what to do,
pop your shit on them.
Don't come up under a small blogger and tell us what to do. See, and the reason why y'all do that shit, because y'all feel like y'all voice to be heard. Y'all know if y'all would have went to No Jumper, Your message wouldn't even be acknowledged. Like, that shit wouldn't even blend it in because the chat would have been going so fucking fast. Your shit wouldn't even be seen. Nah, he talking about Meek Mill, but he ain't playing. But let me tell you, so like, and I got to say this shit again? Once a big platform shed light on something, it's over with. Like, it's out there. Like, I don't know how small-minded a lot of people is, but once a big platform shed light on something, it's no secret. Once Poetic Flacco made his video about Little Durk and Brick Baby and Quando Rondo, it's that shit no secret no more. You know what I'm saying? It's no secret. So yeah, y'all gotta stop that shit. Y'all gotta understand that. Just like if a news, if the news play some shit and say, well, this was game related, and we think da 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 da. And then somebody say something about it on social media, like, the fuck? The news already said it.
Trust me, I get that shit all the time. Ooh.
Yeah, like that. That's crazy to me. If motherfucking Shade Room post some shit, it's already motherfucking, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's already out there. If the Shade Room post it, it's over with. It's out there. Y'all got to understand. Y'all got to stop being small-minded. Like, God damn.
Here, listen. Hey. Shout out music. That shit came full circle, though. I ain't know where we was going at the beginning. But I will say this. Shout out to Blender Bars, because he was still, you know, he came. And even when I asked my questions, because I at first I wasn't going to say nothing. But, hey, he's a good person to interview, though. Because he was okay. I get you, but, you know, da-da-da. And he stuck around in the chat, so that was cool.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. And then let me tell y'all something else for the motherfuckers that's so smart you're dumb. Let me tell you something else. I don't give a fuck what somebody says on the internet. If they not connected to the situation, if they don't have personal knowledge to the people that they talking to, that shit don't even matter for real. It may look something big to you, but if Blender Ball said Big Mill killed sell motherfuckers and he's just a YouTuber, it's gonna get some light. It's gonna make the motherfucker say, hey, damn, like this dude did say this, but it doesn't hold up because he's not even connected to the parties. At this point, you just talking. Like, so y'all gotta really
know. That nigga gave him a zip code, like he a resident of Philly.
He ain't even a resident. So I don't even think he's from Philly, though.
That's what I'm saying, though. But on paper, that shit gonna sound like a motherfucker from that zip code called in to report. And I doubt Meek Mill even stay in Philly, though, like for real.
Meek Mill's better not stay in no motherfucking Philly.
Look at my name. Read what my name say.
I'm an innocent bystander, host. Hey, hold on. I got something for the haters. I made this especially for the haters. Let me play this for the haters real quick.
You hate on a nigga. Why? I don't understand why you hate on me, nigga.
We don't understand.
Show love, nigga. It don't show nothing. It don't cost nothing to show a nigga love.
I was doing
nigga.
This game, money.
Show a nigga some love, nigga.
Wabbledy dabbledy.
I'm
going to
tell you this, though. Okay, because as
fucking dabbledy.
The next time you want to do some police shit, let me know in advance. You don't never tell me about police shit in advance.
Hey,
you just hit me with the shit.
Listen, I ain't gonna lie to you. You see, he ain't up here. I ain't even think about it until I was scrolling through and I seen the No Jumper clip. I'm like, okay, yeah, I forgot about this shit happening. Like, he wasn't even on the docket for real until we were pulling up, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Now, it's cool for me to say docket, but that shit sound real.
Hey, no, I can't help it. You, I got it from you. God damn, docket is just a word. Like, is we gonna associate docket with the police now? Like, God damn.
No, see, like, I think docket because I cover court shit. That's why I say docket.
Hey, but the definition of a docket is I'm using the right word. God damn it.
What is technically the definition of
He ain't on the motherfucking list. He ain't on the program. Shit. That's the program. The docket is the program. God damn it. Is you on the docket? Because them bitches tell you.
Nah, that's not a definition.
No. Legal. Go ahead.
It's a record of proceedings in a legal action, a register of such records, a list of legal causes to be tried. Like the same concept, but
concept. Cause goddamn it, when you go to court, they're gonna say, see, is your name on the docket? Goddamn it, hey, I'm supposed to be.
I told you go ahead, and then you gonna bring up a sentence with court in it.
No, I'm just saying, cause I know for a fact, motherfucker, that cause I done asked the motherfucker. Hey, I supposed to be in this courtroom.
Right, you only use it when it's court related.
Right. But
you know
a nigga gonna use it.
But the shock factor. You definitely A+ on shock factor. Because I even had to get in the chat like, what the fuck is happening? The slasher trailer was everything though. I ain't gonna lie, that shit had me over nervous. Like, the fuck is about to happen at the end of this minute?
ain't gonna even lie. I couldn't even really see the. I was behind on the trailer shit because I'm watching it from the TV. So, but hey, man, like I said, I don't agree with him. You know what I'm saying?
He came up here with the motherfucking snitches news and said, "All right, what the?"
Hey, but I knew he was special when I heard the call. Like I'm telling you, I didn't like because I know he was following me on Instagram. But I didn't know
that was me too. So
right, he followed a lot of us. I didn't know that was him who made the song. So when I posted his video, I say, you know what I'm saying? Because it was a situation where he had wrote the lyrics out on the Quando Rondo shit, right? But somebody on Twitter, you know the lyrics to the Quando Rondo song. About, you know what I'm saying, Lil Durk and Brick Baby.
Oh my gosh, he was in on that too?
I'm saying he, you know how motherfuckers do, like they write what the lyrics is saying. He wrote it out. So it's somebody that's on Facebook who's taking all the people videos on YouTube and posting it to Facebook and Twitter. So I seen the shit, you know what I'm saying? And the little part where I used where he was saying that.
They posting it. What the fuck they posting? What?
It's a guy, I think it's a dude, but he's taking YouTubers' videos and posting it on Facebook and getting paid for it.
Oh, well, I got to start posting my own shit on Facebook.
So that's why I be putting my little shit in there and shit. That's why I be saying, like, y'all got to start putting y'all shit on there because it ain't even a button to, like, let Facebook know, hey, this bitch taking your content type
putting
shit.
Putting what on there? Like, your logo?
Your logo and shit. You know what I'm saying? And somebody took
your shit. Let me find out. I got to go back to having Mickey True all over the screen like I used to have it.
Most definitely got to, though. But I ain't gonna lie though, he don't take out your intros and none of that. He just download your shit and upload that bitch. Like you still have the intro in that bitch and everything. So you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna even lie. Say, what's up with the interview? Hey man, you gotta hit me up on Instagram. We could chop it up. So
and if you don't hit $2 on the other channel, it won't be on Triple Threat Friday. I'll tell you that much. Reek.
Damn. Nah, for sure. So you say if you post on Facebook, pic, reels, and videos, it automatically connect to IG.
Yeah, man, but I just got better because I wasn't posting reels like that, but now I'll be posting reels on IG, TikTok, and on Facebook.
Nah, but this dude on Facebook, he have Seti Nash videos, he got my videos, he got AK videos. He got like all the, you know what I'm saying? He got everybody videos on his shit. And Blender video was on his Twitter. The Quando Rondo lyrics and shit. So
I mean to ask him, what is his overall goal to like meet academics or something? Or is he just trying to be an upcoming blogger or something, a rapper? I meant to ask that.
I don't know. I think he said when he got the track, because I think he a rapper, because if you go down most of the songs, he got songs and then videos after he did the academics. So if I heard him right, he said, I hit you, you never responded. I got to check it out. What's your IG, bro? You probably ain't say the right thing. But he say, and then it depends what IG. I got two IGs and one of them I don't got access to. But he said that once he got the traction from the song, he started dropping videos.
Oh, my man.
So academics probably created a monster. He say he didn't start dropping.
That's fucking Godzilla.
He say he didn't start dropping videos.
What's the other shit? Godzilla and versus who? What's the other thing? Godzilla and
yeah, you taking me out? Nah.
What's the honest. Y'all? Who Godzilla versus what's the other one? Now I know somebody know.
I don't know. King Kong. Trying to say King Kong.
Thank you. I knew something. I know I ain't the only one that know that shit. Y'all have me out here hanging on the leaf. Like, I'm like, hold on, what's the other one?
So look, so everybody feel like y'all feel like that your boy went too far. I feel like he went too far too. I ain't gonna lie, but I, you know what I'm saying? I don't understand, but I understand. You know, some of these people look up to these people, and they just built that. Like, and I say it all the time. Once a person build a cult following,
okay,
it's like
beehive. Y'all ain't never got swarm of bees before,
right? Same shit. The same shit when Cardi B and Nicki Minaj.
They ain't called government officials though.
No, they called. They called and said that Nicki Minaj had guns to somebody head and got a house swatted.
Shit!
Nicki Minaj talked about it.
Don't call following like people. Yeah, but see the thing. See the difference is, and I'm gonna tell you what I'm frowning upon. And y'all know, I'm a silent chat nigga because I be over there in Discord. What they
silent chat nigga?
but. AK be sending his people. See, that be the thing when you get sent off.
Right.
It's not like he, you know, they just did it on their own. He said, what he said when I asked him, AK told us to.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's the difference. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's kind of make it, it's one thing when, you know, people just do what they do by themselves. But right. These is on. Truth King, let me tell y'all. I ain't gonna send y'all none of that shit, okay? I might tell y'all to verify some shit. We gonna do that shit. I'm not gonna send y'all no shit like that.
Right.
Might tell y'all look through some comments for me and send me some screenshots, but yeah.
Say Nikki House got swatted 2 times. Yeah, she say her shit got swatted 2 times.
What's that before the beef though?
Nah, that was
done. That was Nikki and Megan that just had the beef, okay.
Yeah, that was when Nicki and the Cardi situation. You know what I'm saying? And then, and see the thing about that shit be dangerous because the SWAT team come, they get calls like bitch at gunpoint type shit.
And they got to come full throttle and that woman got a baby there, you know?
Right.
Papa wasn't a Poppy or Poppy.
Right. That's what she said. She got Papa Bell there and Baby Bell. And y'all calling the motherfucking SWAT team and the SWAT team kicking in doors, coming in that bitch and Papa Bell and all the spinach gone and carriage and all this shit. And you know what I'm saying?
You that, stupid.
That shit is dangerous though. Like that shit. But that's like, we see it though. Like that's the same thing. Like nobody was in.
Stay up at this point. It's already midnight.
Yeah, it's midnight. But we finna, might well end this, man. It was a great live, man. Y'all done got on Blender ass, man.
Nah, we got on your ass.
hey,
got in your feelings a little bit.
Hey, nah, no, because it be like a lot of people, like, it just don't make sense to me sometimes. Like, y'all will see this shit on the news, and then the bitch be like, why you said something? You finna get them in trouble, bitch. If the news didn't get them in trouble, little me ain't get them in trouble. You know,
definitely just look. The Rico gonna start on Triple Threat Friday. Hopefully, you get 1-on-1 because you had that shit from A to motherfucking Z. That was this shit was beyond okay, beyond a reaction, but it was definitely good content, okay? Because he even implicated Flacco. And I'm definitely clipping that part. And
he
I'm
said
that shit as a real.
But he did say he talked to Flacco behind the scenes.
And Flacco gave him the green light. So now we know AK the leader, and then Flacco next in command. And the reason why he did the Brick Baby and little Durk thing to take the heat off of Dave Rico. There y'all go.
Damn.
There go the storyline. Y'all lucky I ain't that type of YouTuber, because boy, I can come up with some shit, okay? I'll put some shit for sure.
Hey, but I would say this though. Flacco did say he ride with academics now.
I will say that, you know what? It probably was better that you didn't tell me, because my reaction was a true reaction to this shit tonight, okay? Like, this was raw and uncut for sure. Because I was over here like, what the fuck is happening?
No, for sure. Y'all make sure y'all hit that like button and shut it live, man. We finna go ahead and get out of here. Make it do your
yeah, one y'all. I gotta catch a flight in a couple hours. I've been on here longer than I thought I would. Good content, good show, good engagement. Y'all make sure if y'all have not already hit that like button. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe over to Mickey Truth channel. Follow me on all platforms, Mickey Truth 2022. Hey, more stuff to come. Hey, keep rocking with us, okay? Every Wednesday, 8 p.m., Triple Threat, Ladies Edition. Shout out to Camilla Roxy and Miss Me With That BS. Also, hit up LenaLoveLather.com. Get you some truth bar. I was about to say truth team. Get you that truth bar, okay? It smells good, make you feel good, all that, okay? And with that being said, yo, good night. Have a good weekend. And I'll holler at y'all next week.
For sure, for sure. Salute, salute. Hey, appreciate everybody tapping in. Y'all already know, man, we're on the road to 100K. You know what I'm saying? The haters gonna hate, but we gonna keep pushing and keep grinding and keep giving them something to hate about. If you ain't got no haters, you ain't doing nothing. You know what I'm saying? And that's that on that. But salute to everybody that's pulling up, man, supporting the channels. Y'all make sure y'all subscribe to me and Mickey Truth. We're going to bring y'all bangers every fucking time and let y'all know anything on the internet is internet entertainment purposes only. And that's facts. I'm out.
Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. He ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. He ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. He ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. He ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. He ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. Ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. Ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.
Yeah!
50 flow. Ain't Hirachi. Baby, he's all white. These ain't no Hirachi.